The following is a Dowling Catholic Sports presentation on Iowa Catholic Radio. Our coverage of Dowling Catholic Sports is underwritten by Ashworth Vision Clinic, Construction Professionals, Klein Electric, the Catholic Tuition Organization, Fast Signs, Blessman International, Skeffington's Formal Wear, and Bozen the Florist. Thank you for supporting Iowa Catholic Radio.
Do you need a spot for your coat, Mr. Wilson?
Yeah.
Besides giving it to me, yeah. We're going to get a lot of traffic in front of us tonight. All right. Dowling gets a steal, so Ellie Olson with the steal in the backcourt. The Maroons have done that here lately after the Christmas break, Scott. So it's one way to get an extra two, maybe three possessions and see what you can do. Maroons trying to take advantage of a turnover here. Ankeny gets back as soon as the Dowling offense as Ellie waits for him. Here's Zediker with it. Bounce pass to Tritton, and she threw it behind her. Yeah, you're exactly right, Scott. Dowling is just not in sync right now offensively.
Well, and they'd like to go inside to Muller, but right now Ellie Olson's defenders just camping in the lane to make that pass a little more difficult so they can double anything going into the post.
All right, here's a shot in the lane blocked out of bounds by Tritton on the shot by Savannah Gage going down with her left hand on the left side of the lane, out of bounds to Ankeny.
And Dowling can get out of this if they can get some stops and get out and run and get some easy baskets. That's what they really need to do. That's been missing the last couple games.
And down the ball to Keene. Now at the top of the key, it goes to Cassie Johnson. To Keene for three. Good. That's our first 3 points of the night. Ainsley Keene with her 31st made three. She leads the team in made threes, and it's 3-0 Ankeny. Dowling with the ball in the front court. To go left to right. Here's Ellie Muller to Zediker, left baseline. She'll launch the three. It's up. In and out, no good. Offensive, or rebound, rather, out to Ankeny. And in the front corner is Ainsley Keene. Keene, a 5'10 sophomore. Two seniors, a junior, and two sophomores in the starting lineup for head coach Nathan Tomey. And now in the lane, Savannah Gage for Ankeny and draws the foul.
Ankeny being real aggressive, driving right now and getting to the lane and forcing a Dowling to try to stop those drives.
Fouls on Tritton. That is her first. First team foul of the night for the Maroons. And the free throw is good by Savannah Gage. So it's 4-0 Ankeny. Now they're going to ask Keene to leave the ball game. She had blood on her uniform or arm.
Looks like arm.
And substitution for the first time tonight. We will see. Kayla Schatfeld. And the second free throw good. So Gage is now 2-for-2 at the line. It's 5-0 Ankeny over Dowling. 5:45 to go. First quarter from the Ankeny gym. Glad you could join us tonight on Iowa Catholic Radio as we will have a busy week ourselves following the Dowling girls and boys basketball teams through this stretch. Here's Zediker underneath, gets to Olson, out to Ellie Muller for three. It's no good. Rebound Dowling, and Ellie Olson kept it alive. Here's Zediker with it. Brand new shot clock for the Maroons. Man-to-man defense by the Ankeny Hawkettes. Here's Katie Muller with it. In the corner it goes to Olson. Now gets underneath. They lob it inside to Muller, and her shot is blocked out of bounds and safe from going out of bounds into the hands of Ankeny. Hawks come away with it. Here's Gage with it. She stops the free throw line, shoots, and it's no good. And the rebound, Dowling and Ellie Muller.
This is where the Maroons need to get out and run, get their wings out there and hit them down the line for open threes.
Here's Tritton with it. She almost took it all the way to the basket, but was cut off. Now Zediker has it. Zediker guarded by Jayla Williams. That's a great mashup. Zediker dribbles down the left block, can't get a shot off. Out to Muller, and a whistle and a holding foul on Ankeny on the drive by the Maroons.
The Maroons just need to be a little more decisive when they're going to go to drive. They need to rip through and attack that top leg there on the defender to draw those fouls, back them off a little bit.
Kyla Schatfeld with the foul. So each team with a foul here in the first quarter. 5-0 Ankeny. Dowling basketball. They reset the shot clock. Other games going on in the CIML on this Tuesday night. Valley is at Johnston. Ankeny Centennial at Waukee. Southeast Polk at Urbandale. And in a boys-only contest, Grandview Christian at Waukee Northwest. I think the Waukee Northwest girls have the night off. It's the only bye on the schedule. There usually is one per Tuesday or Friday. Here's Zediger. Crossover dribble. Kicks it over in the corner. And a three-pointer up and no good by Ellie Muller. And the rebound out to Jayla Williams and Ankeny. Hawkettes going the other way. Dowling 0 for the field to start the game. Now corner three by Jax is up and no good by Ankeny from the right side. Rebound Dowling. These have not gotten anything going. That's a credit to Ankeny. And now here's Katie Muller down the lane. Gets it out to Zediker. She'll launch the three in the corner. It's short. And the rebound out to Ankeny and Williams. What is the Maroons from the field right now? 0 for what?
0 for 5 from 3, 0 for 6 overall.
Wow. Now underneath, reverse layup. Good. That's Carson Jax with her first 2 points. Timeout Dowling with 3:33 to go here in the 3:33 to go here in the first quarter. 7-0 Ankeny. And guess who comes wandering over on a 30-second timeout? The head JV one coach at Dowling Girls, the legendary and all-purpose Tom Donahue. Remember him?
I do. He's a good guy, but he was just shaking his head at us right now.
You know, the last time I was on the floor besides here was on the floor with him at Cedar Rapids,
right,
Washington, in a regional final. And he came over, did an okay job. I think the listeners, a couple of them got kind of crossed up. They didn't quite know what he said, but
that was the game against Hannah Stolke.
Yeah, Stolke from Iowa.
I remember that.
4 years ago. Yes, yeah. You're right.
That was a crazy game. Dowling was down by 15 in the first half and came all the way back and won.
We weren't too far from you. I think Donahue wanted to go sit next to you because you were on the bench during that game, Scott Babinet.
I was, and it was a weird game.
All right, Dowling gets the ball inside. Zediker has it stolen away from the right block. Tried to post her defender up, and Ankeny comes away with it. Here's Jayla Williams. Dribbles down the lane. Her shot blocked out of bounds by Zediker. And it'll be Hawkette basketball. And they'll inbound it right in front of us as we are sitting on the baseline here at the northwest corner of the Ankeny gym near the Dowling bench. Hawkettes throw it in. This is Jax. Carson in the lane. Her shot partially blocked by Tritton, rebounded by Dowling and Ellie Muller. Outlet pass down court to Tritton. And Ankeny gets back on defense. Rather, this is Katie Muller. Her pass inside to her sister, stolen away. Carson Jax with the steal. 3-on-2 fast break. Layup good by Jayla Williams.
Yeah, Ankeny's just doing a good job getting out and running and finishing here right now. And Dowling's kind of chasing their tails a little bit.
Now Zediker in the lane. Her shot up, no good. Ball tipped out of bounds, and they went off of Ellie Muller as the shot is no good. Oh, my goodness. What a way to start the game. 9-0 Ankeny leading Dowling. Now, the Maroons had another bad start, and that was at the holiday tournament at Johnson where they were down. They were actually shut out at the end of the first quarter, Scott.
Right. It was 13-0 after the first 10 minutes, and then they started to get used to that zone a little bit. But right now, they're just not getting enough ball movement. A lot of dribbling and not enough passing to move the defense and make them compromise.
Macy Harnden in the lineup for Dowling Catholic. She replaces Ellie Olson with the first Dowling substitution. 2:10 to go. It's 9-0 Ankeny in the first quarter of this Class 5A top 5 matchup, top 10 matchup in girls basketball. 2 on the shot clock. I hear the shot at the horn. It's no good. Rebound Ellie Muller. Outlet pass to the Maroons to her sister Katie. There's Zediker trailing on the right side. Ava will dribble between the circles.
Yeah, Ava's seeing two defenders just waiting for her every single time.
And Dowling works it inside, and double-teamed is Ellie Muller, but she gets the shot to go. Shot off the glass good by Ellie, and she has 2 points, 9-2. Ankeny, minute 35 left to go in the first quarter, so the Dowling about 6.5 minutes without a score to start the game. And now here's a shot top of the key, no good by Williams. Offensive rebound, Ankeny and Jade Moser. The Hawkettes retain possession. Now shot at the elbow. It's no good by Ainsley Keene. Rebound Dowling. This is Macy Harnden with it. Stops between the circles. Leaves it for Tritton. She dribbles to the basket, gets underneath to Katie Muller, and her shot up and good. Check that, Ellie Muller with the basket. She has all four of Dowling's points, and now the ball movement is starting to happen.
Right. And the drives are made with purpose. They're getting down to the lane and drawing the defender away, and Muller's just opening up, which is another staple of what Dowling wants to have.
Johnson with the basketball. This is Ainsley Keene with it. Top of the key, she leaves it for Jack. She'll launch the three. It's no good. Rebound, Ellie Muller. Outlet pass to Zediker. Ava down the lane. Leaves it for Katie Muller for three. Up, no good. And the rebound out to Johnston and Carson Jacks. The other way we go. We get it down court to Ainsley Keene. Her shot up and no good. And Scott, you're going to have to help him out. That noise you heard with Scott. Radio's got to help out. I was very impressed, Mr. Babinat. You hustled. You didn't let it go to the other gym down the hallway. You're getting your
stats.
I
didn't get hit in the face.
You didn't get hit in the face, and you didn't delay the game.
And they said thank you.
And they did.
Thanks. I didn't get many thank yous from referees back in the day, so I'll take that as a win.
All right, here's the steal by Dowling. Tritton with the steal. Down court to Ellie Olson. Layup good. Ellie back in the lineup. And shooting and scoring, and it's 9-6 now. Ankeny with the lead. 3 seconds remaining. And now here's Keene for three at the horn. It's no good, and we've come to the end of the first quarter here at the Ankeny Gym with the score. Ankeny 9, Dowling Catholic 6, alongside Scott Babinat, Mark Amadil. We'll return for the second quarter here in this Central Iowa Metro League doubleheader, and it's the Ankeny girls leading Dowling 9-6. Back with the second quarter in 1 minute here on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio comes from Westgate Dental, offering cosmetic, family, implant, and general dentistry. Located at 1073rd Street, Suite 1 in West Des Moines, just behind Dowling Catholic High School. Learn more at westgatedentalia.com.
Support for programming is provided by Construction Professionals, serving customers through a proven process, creating unique design, functionality, and artistic beauty. Construction Professionals is a Catholic family business built on a strong foundation. CPCustomHomes.com.
Fast Signs is a custom sign and visual solutions company with an extensive selection of digital signage, interior and exterior signs, banners, and vehicle wraps. Learn more at fastsigns.com. Thank you, Fast Signs in Clive, for your support of Iowa Catholic Radio.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio is provided by Bozen the Florist. Valentine's Day, Mother's Day, weddings, whatever the message, say more with Bozen. Bozen.com. 515-244-ROSE. Bozen makes the moment mean more.
And we're underway here in the second quarter here at the Ankeny Gym. And it's Ankeny leading Dowling 9-6. The Hawkettes were 2-for-2 at the free throw line in the first quarter. Dowling did not attempt a free throw. Now the Hawkettes with the ball and a steal by Olson. Ellie with another steal. And boy, I'll tell you what, she is leading the team in defense right now, as she always is. He'll lob it inside to Muller. Now the reverse pass to Harnden, and Macy has to save it from going over and back. 20 on the shot clock. Dowling trailing by three. Here's Zediker, dribbles down the left side. Gets cut off, leaves it for Olson, right wing. Now back to Zediker, top of the key. Dribbles in the lane, leaves it underneath. Gets it back to Harnden for three, and it's no good. Offensive rebound, Dowling to Tritton. Back to Olson. Hawkett stay man-to-man. And now Zediker will work with a brand-new shot clock that's been reset. There's Olson underneath, pull-up jumper, good. Ellie Olson shoots and scores. They're going to let her shoot. We saw that Friday night against Johnston.
And they're going to let her get into the lane, so she needs to finish there if she gets a chance.
Now, a steal by who else? Ellie Olson, but they whistle her for over and back, and now a timeout called by the Hawks. The Hawkettes, rather, and head coach Nate Toby in his first year after being the assistant boys coach here at Ankeny for 7 years. I want to thank our supporters of Iowa Catholic Radio tonight. They include Fast Signs, Blessman International, along with Skeffigan's Formal Wear and the Catholic Tuition Organization. Alongside Scott Babinat, Mark Amadil, Jimmy Cataldo will join us later if he can get through security. I don't know. That's usually 50-50 sometimes.
I don't know. I say I'm with the radio, and they say, okay, go on in. So I don't know if he makes it. They make it that easy for him.
Well, they shouldn't, to be quite honest. Yeah, I got to show them different forms of ID until I get the Iowa Public Television guy, Paul Yeager, who's doing the video live stream tonight, and say he'll vouch for me.
Yeah,
one of the few times he does. But 9-8 is our score. Dowling has not had the lead, and now the Hawkettes turn it over on an errant pass to Jayla Williams. So Dowling will throw it in, and now a substitution for the Maroons. Katie Moeller returns to the lineup, replacing her sister Ellie.
Maybe I just have an honest face, Mark.
You
don't
do,
know.
Scott.
Because Paul wouldn't know me from anybody else in this crowd.
Paul and Mr. 5A Assistant Football Coach of the Year, Andy Pollock, thanks to them for letting me in the door. That's all I can really say. That's why we're by the door. They have to leave soon. All right, Dowling with the ball. They trail by one, looking for their first lead. They could take it here. 6:20 to go, second quarter. Zediker dribbles right side, double team. Now gets a backdoor cut to Tritton. In the corner it goes, a long shot up and no good by Katie Moeller. Offensive rebound, who else? Ellie Olson. Olson's reverse pass stolen away by Ainsley Keene and Ankeny.
And they're running some screen and roll with Ellie Olson right now. She just needs to drop in that middle, right, you know, where there nobody is. So she's an outlet, and she could finish that shot inside the lane.
Here's Jax with it for Ankeny. Right wing, it goes to Jayla Williams. Now a skip pass over in the corner to Cassie Johnson for three. Her shot's no good. Rebound Dowling and Tritton. Outlet pass to Zediker. Maroons are running. Zediker dribbles all the way down the elbow. Pick it up. Dowling will set their offense here with 25 in the shot clock. Here's Harnden with it. Macy dribbles to the right side. Gets down the right block. Tries a reverse pass. Stolen away by Williams. Here come the Hawkettes. Lead pass down court to Jackson. She threw it away.
And, you know, Harnden does a really good job coming in. When she gets herself into trouble, she gets too deep down the lane. And she doesn't need to do that early on in the shot clock. She could get down, probably step sooner, kick it out, rotate through, and get it. The second time, she might have the opening all the way to the basket. But she gets in too deep. The defenders are waiting, and she's not tall enough to get it past them.
And Dowling's still waiting for their first lead. They trail 9-8 as the Hawkettes, out to a 9-0 lead before Dowling scored. Here's Zediker with it in the lane. And now a pull-up jumper, good as she was hit as she shot the ball. But Ava gives Dowling its first lead and her first 2 points with 4:50 to go here in the first quarter.
And even on that play, there's a good finish by Zediker. But Olson sets a nice screen and just, well, she just has to show her numbers and call for that ball. She's going to be wide open for a layup.
Hawkettes underneath. The shot to left hand, no good by Cassie Johnson. Gets her own rebound, put back up and no good, and she's fouled by Harnden. And two free throws coming for Cassie Johnson, one of three seniors on this team of Ankeny. Harnden picks up her first foul. And Johnson, a 83% free throw shooter, will go to the line here, Scott. And she eyes the bucket. First free throw is no good. Tonight's game on Iowa Catholic Radio brought to you in part by Klein Electric, Construction Professionals, and Ashworth Vision Clinic.
And Johnson's one of the players, much like they're sagging off of Olson. Dowling's sagging off of her to give her opportunities to make her prove it. So
Johnson's second free throw, good. So she goes 1-for-2. Hawkettes now 3-of-4 at the free throw line. Dowling has yet to attempt a free throw. 11-10 is our score. Dowling with a, or rather 10-all is 10. Our score.
I was wondering how that score with one free throw.
Put it in the wrong column. Now Dowling with the ball. Here's Ellie Moeller, top of the key now to Zediker. Zediker coming off the ball screen by Moeller. Cut off nicely by Williams. To get in the corner to Olson. Underneath to Ellie Moeller, layup good. Great pass by Ellie Olson to Moeller.
And she's doing a lot of nice things. You know, if Ellie realized, you know, last game, it was the first time you said that in her career, she was leading the Maroons in scoring at halftime. She has the ability to put the ball in the basket, but because she hasn't, you know, she needs to look for that a little bit more, especially in the lane.
All right, here's a long three by Keen. It's no good for Ankeny from the top of the key. Rebound Dowling. Zediker gets it down to Olson. Back to Zediker, along three right wing. Good, right in front of the Ankeny Hawkette bench. Ava Zediker with her fifth point. And a timeout called by the Hawks. Dowling's lead is now five. This is their largest lead. And this will be a full timeout. We'll take it with them with 3:29 to go, second quarter. Dowling Catholic 15, Ankeny 10, here on Iowa Catholic Radio.
The word Christian was first used by non-believers who intended to mock Christians. It meant a little Christ. The Christians in turn adopted the term as a badge of honor. To be a Christian means that we are called to be little Christs. For like Jesus, we are called to announce the good news, heal the sick, bring relief to the suffering, and justice to the oppressed. And yet we must recall that Jesus also said his followers must take up their cross and follow me. In other words, every Christian will at some point face suffering and opposition. Through suffering, we are brought to our knees and drawn closer to God. We can also offer up our suffering as a sacrifice on behalf of others. And yet there is a still deeper understanding of suffering. For it was through the worst evil the world has ever seen and the crucifixion of the Son of God that God brought about the greatest good, the redemption of mankind. In some mysterious way, then, God uses the suffering of his people to bring about a greater good and so give him greater glory. We may not fully understand suffering in this life, but we can trust in God's goodness and say with Job, "The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord." This is Greg Ewell for Faith Check.
And we're back here at the Ankeny Gym. The Hawkettes coming out of the timeout. A shot up and no good. And a rebound comes out to Dowling. So the Hawkettes really quick and now traveling called on Ellie Olson. And Scott, what are those numbers looking like thus far with 3:10 left in the first half?
Well, the first quarter numbers were Dowling was 3 for 11 from the field, 0 for 6 and 3. No free throws, 8 rebounds, 1 offensive, 4 turnovers, which was troublesome. The Hawks were 3 for 15, 1 for 5 from 3, 2 for 2 from the line in the first quarter, 10 rebounds, 4 of them offensive, and 2 turnovers.
Dowling's outscored Ankeny 9-1 here in the second quarter. And with 2:45 to play here in the half, Dowling by 5. And now a turnaround jumper by Keene is no good. Rebound Dowling. Katie Muller leading the charge, gets it down court. Ball slapped out of bounds, or slapped from her by Cassie Johnson, who picks it up. Now the Hawks the other way. Hawkettes, rather. Here is Carson Jacks in the front court, guarded by Katie Muller.
Both teams are making it difficult for each other defensively, but you can't have those just giveaways like that.
Now Keene for three, right wing, in and out, no good. Rebound Ellie Muller. Ellie will take it across the timeline. Leaves it for Zediker. Ava, a jump stop, right wing. Surveys the court. Skip pass over to the left side to Katie Muller. Now to Ellie Olson. Now in the lane, a pull-up jumper no good by Zediker. Ball slapped around into the hands of Katie Muller. Katie underneath, shot off the glass, good. Katie Muller with her first 2 points. Dowling's on 11-1 run here in the second quarter.
And again, they're making it hard for Ankeny right now. Ankeny came out of the last timeout, little shoulder slumps on the body language, kind of like a feel of here we go again. And Dowling needs to keep pressing on them to not give them any chance that they feel like they can get back into this game at this point.
That was a turnover. Or no, it was not. It was Dowling basketball. They run a little high-low to Ellie Muller. Layup good. Katie with the assist, and her sister gets the basket. She has 8 points here, does Ellie Muller. 19-10, Dowling's increased its lead to 9. So after trailing by 9, they lead by 9.
It's been quite the turnaround quarter for the Maroons.
No question about it. They hung right in there. Here's Gage with it. Top of the key, it goes to Williams. She spins against Zediker. It's stolen away by Zediker. Caught her in the air. Ava with the strip and steal. And dribbles in the front court. They lob it inside to Muller. Her layup's good. Just a quick turn and score. Muller.
And that's a good matchup. Zediker and Williams going at each other on both ends.
Muller with 10 points. She had 4 in the first quarter and has 6 here in the second quarter. Under a minute to play, 21-10, Dowling by 11. Ankeny has been held to one free throw in this second quarter. Now we got a whistle and a foul on Dowling. And they're going to whistle it on Layla Tritt, and that'll be her second. And she'll step out of the lineup, replaced by Dowling's Macy Harnden. So it'll be Harnden, Olson, both Muller sisters.
Zedeker,
yeah.
You can't forget her.
Ankeny with the basketball. Here's Gage with it. Wants to go to the basket on the right side against Olson. They won't let her, and the ball tipped out of bounds. With 19 on the shot clock here.
Ellie Olson's doing a really good job defensively. You know, and again, I'm telling you at the break, I feel repetitive, but she's doing a really nice job defensively, helping keep Dowling early on in the game, and then just keeping the pressure up.
Right, about a 10-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. 7 on the shot clock, 17 seconds remaining in the quarter. Now, corner three by Joensen is blocked by Ellie Muller, and that'll be a shot clock violation. They're going to keep the ball alive. 8 seconds remaining. Zedeker gets it across half court, lobs it inside, and a shot by Ellie Olson is no good. Offensive or Maddie Anselmi with the rebound, and the half court shot bounces off the rim, no good. And we go to halftime with Dowling Catholic overcoming a 9-0 deficit to lead it 21-10. Here at halftime, Scott Babinet, and boy, the Bruins found a way to outscore Ankeny 15-1 in that second quarter.
Yeah, that's a great turnaround. Their defense allowed them to stay in it early on. They didn't panic, and then they started getting the ball inside and get some easy shots. The shooting totals will be much better for Dowling in the second quarter.
Well, the Bruins dug themselves out of a hole by holding the Hawkettes to one free throw in that second quarter. We're at halftime. We're going to catch up with Dowling Catholic head boys basketball coach Justin Einerson. We'll take a one-minute break here. We want to thank Brady Grimm back at the Iowa Catholic Radio Studios as he sits in tonight. I think he has somebody from Oot Feedem sitting in with him, and we appreciate that young lady sitting in on the board tonight, and that is Alexia alongside Scott Babinet, Mark Amadale. Halftime here at the Ankeny Gym. Dowling Catholic girls leading Ankeny 21-10. We'll be back in 1 minute on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio comes from the Catholic Tuition Organization. Reduce or eliminate your Iowa income tax and instead give to the Catholic Tuition Organization and receive 75% Iowa tax credits. These tax credits are going fast, so reserve yours today and learn more about the Catholic Tuition Organization at ctoiowa.org. ctoiowa.org. The bottom line, it's for the kids and their futures.
Catholic Tuition Organization, a great investment in our kids.
Support for programming is provided by Construction Professionals, serving customers through a proven process, creating unique design, functionality, and artistic beauty. Construction Professionals is a Catholic family business built on a strong foundation. CPCustomHomes.com.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio is provided by Ashworth Vision Clinic. Complete eye exams, contact lenses, glasses, glaucoma testing, and urgent eye issues. 515-440-4610. AshworthVision.com.
Welcome back to the Ankeny Gym. Alongside Scott Babinet, Mark Amadale, we are here courtside. I don't know if this view gets any better. Dowling girls leading 21-10 here at halftime, joined by Justin Einerson, Dowling boys basketball coach. As he gets set for his game against Ankeny, the rematch. We go from a low-scoring game against your nemesis, Courtney Henderson, formerly at Hoover, now at Johnson, go from a low-scoring to Scott Carlson and his up-tempo Ankeny team. You guys were in the 70s last time you played right before Christmas. So what are we going to expect tonight on the rematch, Coach?
Hopefully something in the middle. you know, the 40 to 47 is not real good. And then when it's 79-77, there's a lot of things to fix there as well. It is a little bit interesting to go back and watch games from that time because I just feel like we're so much better than what we were back then. So especially defensively. So I'm excited about this matchup. I think we've come a long way, and you know, we're in the dog days of the season, so these come fast and often. So we got to have that mentality of anyone, anywhere, anytime.
Well, you lose a day of practice because you have a makeup game Thursday against crosstown rival Valley at the Valley Gym. So one day of practice, that's tomorrow, and that's, I don't know if it's limited or not because it's a Wednesday night and everybody's
pretty
out
limited.
Of the gym.
Yeah.
But you get one day to prepare, but that's what you're up against now with that one makeup, and it affects this week.
Yeah, when we got through that snowstorm, one of the things we did is we tried to simplify everything that we were doing. And, you know, we could plug in and change things on the fly, and it wouldn't be something that's outside of our comfort zone. So I do feel like we're – I might have said this a couple of weeks ago, but I feel like we're at the point now where everybody understands what we're trying to do, and it feels like I've been here for a year. So that's an advantage at this point.
It seems like a year.
It seems like a year.
On the other side of Christmas. That's good stuff. Well, Coach, what do you expect out of your team? I know Friday night against Joensen, up and down, you were right in it. You were out of it for a while. You were down 10, maybe 12 in the third quarter. Came back, battled, got it to 2. And the Dragons won by 7, but your kids are always competing, and your losses have been close. But now you want to try to find that way to make it from a few point loss to a win, and that's going to start here with playing Ankeny the second time.
Want to change it from moral victories to actual victories.
There you go.
You know, we did it at Waukee and weren't able to get it done Friday. We are 1 of 15 from the rim, which is a stat I've never seen before. But if you look at our shot chart, on the left and right side of the rim in the paint, we were 1 of 15. So it's hard to figure out how that happens. I've seen like 5 for 15, but never 1 for 15. 5 of 15 would have won it. So learned a lot. Had a really good couple of practices since, and I feel like we're ready to go today.
So, Coach, did I see right? One of your players got an offer this week?
Yeah, actually a couple. We had Joey Coppola got 2, 1 from Cornell, 1 from Simpson, and then Riddick Metten got another one that I don't think I can mention yet, but that's exciting. And you know, we have a lot of guys getting interest at the D3 level, NAIA level, and a little bit at the JUCO level as well. So it's pretty cool because when I came in, you know, I didn't hear a lot of rumblings about what we had. And man, I tell you what, after 6 months with these guys, I would definitely recruit them to the college level. So it's nice to see.
Yeah, one of the young men, you forgot Aliyer, didn't he get?
Yeah, Aliyer too.
Aliyer Agao.
And then Ryan Kleppe. Ryan Kleppe's got a, I don't think it's a full ride, but it's close to Briarcliff. And yeah, I mean, what is that, 4 guys already we just mentioned? And we got a couple that are trying to go into coaching. So Jackson Trine, who's basically Coach Trine already on our bench, is hoping to go be a manager at UNI for the boys. And Cole Southard may be talking to Iowa for those boys as well from managing. And, you know, I'm a Division I manager myself, so if you want to get into coaching, that is the best way to go, in my opinion.
No question about it. Well, Cole's a pretty good baseball player, too. You don't forget that summer
sport. He's got some stuff to get through before he gets to his basketball dreams, because he is a good baseball player.
Yes, he is. A visit with Justin Einerson, the Dowling boys basketball coach. At halftime of the girls' contest here in Ankeny, 21-10. Dowling girls leading Ankeny. And, Coach, what... you know, let's talk a little bit about your team. We know the opponent. You're going to play Ankeny for the second time. A 2-point loss back in December. I think that was our final broadcast before the Christmas break. But and it might have been Dowling's too. Mm-hmm. Talk about your team and what do you like? The rotations you had. You've had some success. I know last week getting a doubleheader sweep at Waukee. That's a big win. And I see Waukee has moved up in the rankings this week and on the boys' side. So there's a lot of things to look forward to. But then that's how tough the league is. You know that as well as anybody, whether you're at the bottom end or the top end of the league. Anybody can knock another off. And now you're just looking for anybody going to rise to the top. And you're looking to do that with your group.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you look at our schedule and you see that top 10 – or I'm sorry, you look at the top 10 in the state and you look at our schedule, and we have some really, really good wins. We also have some really disappointing losses that we could have had. So I feel like we're right where we deserve to be. But I also feel like the next couple of weeks could really turn in our favor. So we've been kind of beaten at the door trying to get away from 500. And, you know, the best way to do it would be to win 2 or 3 this week, setting up into a part of our schedule that's a little bit more favorable. And right now we're sitting at the second toughest schedule in the state. And, you know, that exists for about three more games, and then I feel like it turns in our favor. So getting a win here would be absolutely huge, and our guys are excited. I think we play like we're the underdog most nights, and that's worked for us. So we'll pretend we are tonight, whether or not we are.
what's the challenge against Ankeny?
Because Carson Johnson.
But you guys did a pretty good job on him. The first time you played him, you held him to 24 points.
Was it Luke Anderson? I think had 3 or 4 threes, and I was trying to think of the other guys.
Yeah, Luke Anderson had 11 points, and he did have 3 threes.
Yeah, and that was big, and then Cash. So Cash, is it Schoolin?
Cash Schoolin off the, yeah.
Those two guys really beat us, I thought, because, you know, you can live with Carson scoring whatever he does, and 24 that night, he can score up to 30. it's when those other guys get into double figures where you're really in trouble.
Aguirre brothers aren't too bad either.
They're good players. I mean, they're a three-headed monster with some really good role players. And if they in games where they can get stops, they are very, very good. So we're going to try to make it as tough on them to do that as possible.
All right. What's the key tonight for Dowling's success?
Pace. Pace. I think we need to play fast, but we need to get to the free throw line more than we shoot the three. And we've been working on that. Hopefully that's what you'll see tonight. The math works out better that way.
Exactly. Well, Coach, appreciate the visit with us. If you have a chance, stop by after the game. Will the bus be leaving?
Oh, I'll be here. They can wait for me.
I thought they might. Appreciate that. I never heard that out of Babinet when he coached. You know? So now the bus is going. I can't visit. So, Coach Anderson, best of luck tonight. Thanks for visiting with us.
Thank you.
All right, Justin Anderson, the Dowling boys basketball coach. We'll come back with our halftime statistics of the girls contest in game one. Mark Amadale, Scott Babinet. We got them all totaled up. We'll give them to our listening audience, and that is you that are listening out there, alongside Scott Babinet, Mark Amadale, and our thanks to Brady Grimm. And Alexia back at the Iowa Catholic Radio Studios. Alexia, part of the Oot Feed'em program at Dowling. We appreciate you both. And we'll be back with the second half and statistics coming up here on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio is provided by Ashworth Vision Clinic. Complete eye exams, contact lenses, glasses, glaucoma testing, and urgent eye issues. 515-440-4610, ashworthvision.com.
Support for programming funded by Blessman International. We bring the good news of the gospel to South African children and their families through faith formation and locally sustainable programs. As the Fellowship of Christian Athletes location for all South Africa, our Sports for Christ complex provides student access to friendly competition where discipline and dedication are developed. Learn how you can support programs like Sports for Christ or experience the hands-on engagement of a mission trip at blessmaninternational.org.
Support for programming is provided by Construction Professionals, serving customers through a proven process, creating unique design, functionality, and artistic beauty. Construction Professionals is a Catholic family business built on a strong foundation. CPCustomHomes.com.
KWKY Des Moines, K233BT Des Moines, KIHS Adel.
And we're back here at the Ankeny Gym, underway here in the second half. Dowling has the first possession. They work it around. And was that Ellie Olson that scored there, Scott?
That was. Right, nice little dump-off pass by Zedeker.
Yeah, Zedeker gets the assist. Olson gets the basket. And for Ellie, that is her 6 point. Now, Ankeny the other way. They get a shot in the lane. It's no good. Get their own rebound. And then the rebound shot is blocked by Mueller. Outlet pass goes to Dowling. Here's Katie Mueller down court. Her layup up and good. The basket will count and a foul on the Hawkettes. So Katie Mueller with her 4th point with an and one here. And Scott?
And Dowling's finally got into their break a little bit more.
Yeah, a little bit. Let's take a look at some numbers from the first half.
Okay, in the first half, Dowling shot 10 for 22 from the field, 1 for 9 from 3. They were 0 for 0 from the free throw line, 18 rebounds, 4 of them offensive, 9 turnovers. For Ankeny, 3 for 23 from the field, 1 for 9 from 3. 3 for 4 from the line, 12 rebounds, 5 of them offensive, and 7 turnovers.
All right, the Hawkettes with the basketball, 15 on the shot clock. Dowling has their largest lead of 15 points right now. They trailed by as many as 9 to start the game. They trailed 9-0. Now a backdoor pass by Ankeny is stolen away by Katie Mueller. Here's Dowling. Outlet pass goes to Ellie Olson. Dribbles across the timeline. Looking to get underneath to Ellie Mueller. Can't do it. Reverse pass stolen away by Ankeny. Jayla Williams with the steal and her layup up with the left hand. No good. Rebound Dowling and Zedeker. So both teams trading turnovers. Zedeker in the lane. Kicks over to Tritton. Layla for three right in front of us. In and out. No good. And the rebound by Ankeny and Savannah Gage.
That did look good leaving her hands though. Bouncing and out. Man.
So the Hawkettes the other way and a shot in the lane. Good. By Savannah Gage. So Gage with her 4th point. And it's 25-12 Dowling. Maroons lob underneath and an offensive foul on the Maroons. They're going to get Mueller for the push-off. So Ellie with her first foul.
I think her arm might have gotten extended there.
The arm bar?
Yeah.
Can't do that. So Ellie with her first foul. Foul trouble for Dowling. Layla Tritton with 2 fouls in that first half for Ankeny. Nobody in foul trouble. I think Schatfeld had the lone foul, so very clean game. Officials, Mark Flegel, Matt Roberts, and Dan Beating. Appreciate having them tonight for both games. 15 on the shot clock. Hawkettes with it. Now a corner three up and off the back iron. No good by Keene. And a jump ball on the rebound on the weak side. Ellie Olson at the bottom of that pile, if you will. It'll be Ankeny Hawk basketball, so the Hawkettes will throw it in.
Dowling, oh, go ahead.
Go ahead, Scott.
Dowling just needs to continue to be solid on their defensive end, come down and execute. Get a stop, go score. Don't let Ankeny think they have a lot of hope come back in the second half.
So here's Williams with the ball, and she dribbles baseline. Layup is good. Williams.
That's your turn.
Ricochet out. So Keene with the basket for Ankeny, and then the Maroons get the ball down court quickly. Keene with 5 points, and Dowling throws it away. The leading scorer for Dowling was Ellie Muller with 10 points at halftime. Ava Zediker with 5 points. Ellie Olson with 6 points, and Katie Muller with 4 points. Dowling has yet to shoot a free throw in this contest, and now a whistle and a foul on Ellie Olson. That'll be her first. Second team foul on Dowling here in the third quarter. For Ankeny, their leading scorer is Ainsley Keene with 5 points. 4 points for Savannah Gage. Carson Jacks with 2 points. Jayla Williams with 2 points. And 1 point for Cassie Johnson. The Hawkettes have been at the free throw line 4 times tonight. They are 3 of 4 at the line. First free throw up and good by Carson Jacks.
And we had Harnden come in for Olson.
So Ellie will have a seat on the bench. And now Katie Muller's pass to Harnden is nearly stolen away by Savannah Gage.
Dowling defensively got a little lazy the last couple possessions. They're not moving their feet and stopping those drives soon enough.
Dowling lobs it into Ellie Muller. Layup good. Off the glass, she was posting up on Cassie Johnson at 5'7", and Ellie at 6'1", won that battle. She has 12 points.
And that's kind of the difference of having Harnden in the game, because she is a perimeter threat. So that opens up that backside if they stay out on her.
4:15 to go, third quarter. 27-15, Dowling by 12. Maroons have led by as many as 15. Now reverse layup, no good by Ankeny. Jacks with the offensive rebound. They'll get a brand new shot clock with 4 minutes to play in the third. Miner will have both games tonight here on Iowa Catholic Radio, Dowling girls and the Dowling boys here at the Ankeny Gym. I want to thank Mike Baker and all the folks here at Ankeny getting us set up. And now a shot in the lane, no good by Ankeny. Rebound Ellie Muller and Dowling. Zediker, 3-on-2 fast break. It's in the corner to Tritton. Now back to Zediker. And now everybody else gets back. Here's Katie Muller for three. Up off the back iron, no good. Offensive rebound, her sister Ellie. She has the ball slapped out of her hands into the hands of Katie Muller. Now the ball goes out of bounds, and it went off of Ankeny. Maybe. That's what your former.
She's not trying to happy. Get a. She usually doesn't say much.
Coach Meyer trying to plead her case there, and it'll be Ankeny basketball. But when Ellie, or rather Katie Muller, was on the floor, it deflected off the shin of a Hawkette. But nonetheless, we go the other way. 27-15, Dowling. 3:15 to go, third quarter. Harnden is guarding Carson Jacks right now. They get it to Keene. Keene dribbles in the lane against Katie Muller. Now jump stops. They rotate the ball. Top of the key is Cassie Johnson for the Hawkettes. 12 on the shot clock. Over to Kyla Schatfeld. Back to Johnson. 5 on the shot clock. Here's Schatfeld with it. Dribbles baseline. Her shot up off balance. That'll be a shot clock violation on Ankeny. Dowling the other way. Here's Zediker leading the charge. In the lane, lobs it to Ellie Muller. Layup is good. 14 points for Muller.
Muller's doing a much better job tonight getting herself open for those little dump-off passes.
And the Hawkettes cannot close out Zediker. If you let her go and gets below that free throw line, that's not good news. Now in the lane, a shot that dribbles off the rim. No good by Jayla Williams. Rebound Dowling again. Zediker, this time she stopped at the elbow. Dowling will set their offense. In the corner, it's Tritton to Moeller. Ellie off the glass, a shot good from the right side. Ellie Moeller with 16 points.
And Zedeker hasn't scored a lot tonight, but her defensive effort has been excellent at the other end against Williams.
Dowling has its largest lead of 16 points, 31-15 over Ankeny. Minute 50 to go here in the third quarter. Hawkettes rotate the ball on the perimeter. Here's Jack's right wing guard, guarded by Harnden, dribbles baseline. Macy gets her under control and makes her reverse the ball. Now the pass up top to Jayla Williams. And a 15-footer up and no good by Williams with the shot. Rebound Dowling, and Ellie Moeller gets it to her sister Katie. Now to Harnden. In the corner goes to Zedeker. Fakes a three. Tries to dribble in and can't. And the Maroons will work their offense. There's Harnden with it. Trying to post up Katie Moeller. And now Zedeker will shoot the three. It's good from the left wing. Ava Zedeker with 8 points. And that is her 34th three of the year.
He just backed off one step too many there.
Yeah. And Dowling by 19. 34-15 with 50 seconds remaining. 20 on the shot clock. Ankeny with the basketball. Here's Cassie Johnson with it. Jump stops and pitches asked for help. And it'll be possession Dowling with 41 seconds to go.
And again, Dowling's playing Cassie Johnson, making her drive into the lane to them, and her little kick out there went off the Ankeny player's hands out of bounds.
All right, here's Zedeker with it with 32 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Dowling 34, Ankeny 15 here at the Ankeny Gym. Glad you could join us tonight on Iowa Catholic Radio, girl-boy doubleheader. We'll do it again Thursday and Friday with a makeup game against Valley on Thursday. Here's Harnden for three on the pass from Zedeker. It's no good, but the rebound cleared out of there by Dowling and Katie Moeller. To Zedeker, she'll launch the three again. It's off the mark, no good. And the rebound, Ankeny and Jade Moser, who's in there, 5'11 junior. Now a shot at the horn, no good. They'll wave it off anyway. And we've come to the end of three quarters of play here at the Ankeny Gym. Our score, Dowling Catholic 34, Ankeny 15. Alongside Scott Babinet, I'm Mark Amadill, and we'll return with the fourth quarter in the Central Iowa Metro League Class 5A top 10 matchup. And it's third-ranked Dowling leading seventh-ranked Ankeny 34-15. We'll return in 1 minute on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network.
Iowa Catholic Radio is supported by our listeners and business underwriters as we connect listeners to Christ while bridging the gap between the church and the marketplace, seeking God in both. If you own a business that you'd like to use to help further this mission, email deaconmark@iowacatholicradio.com. And we encourage you to thank the many businesses who choose to underwrite programming on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network. Your presence is vital as we participate in the church and the marketplace, seeking God in both.
Brightside Aesthetics by Ducharme Dermatology provides advanced and medical aesthetics, body contouring, wellness, and spa services. Learn more at brightsideiowa.com. Thank you, Brightside Aesthetics, for your support of Iowa Catholic Radio.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio comes from Mercy One. Live your best life with Mercy One. With Iowa's largest network of care locations, personalized care is right in your neighborhood. Schedule online at mercyone.org.
And we're back here at the Ankeny Gym. We begin the fourth quarter. Dowling Catholic 34, Ankeny 15 in game one of our girl-boy doubleheader. Dowling girls with the basketball to start the fourth quarter. The Maroons outscored Ankeny 13-5 in that third quarter to open up a 19-point lead. This is Dowling's largest lead of the contest. Hard to believe, Scott. The Maroons got down 9-0 to start the contest.
Yeah, that was a crazy start for them.
Now the Maroons get the ball inside. And they shoot and score, and that is Kelly Olson with her 8th point. Might be getting on near career high here, Scott. All right, here's Savannah Gage with it in the lane. Her shot up and no good. Rebound, Ellie Moeller. Outlet pass to Olson. She saves it right to Tritton in the lane. Layup good. What hustle by Ellie Olson. Tritton with her first 2 points of the night, if you can believe that.
Yeah, that she had a great game last week, and then last Tuesday, and then Friday night she struggled. What a great save and assist there.
Great hustle by Ellie Olson. Now down the lane, and the shot by Jayla Williams is blocked by Ellie Moeller. Rebound Dowling. The Maroons bring it across the timeline, leading 38-15. As the Maroons have doubled the score and then some. 23-point lead for the Maroons over Ankeny. 15 on the shot clock. Here's Zediker. Works the right side. Gets to Ellie Olson. Olson, she'll launch the three. It's no good. Off the back iron. Offensive rebound, Ellie Moeller. It's it out to Zediker. The Maroons, the brand new shot clock. Zediker picks up her dribble. Gets it to Ellie Olson, top of the key. Now she'll launch the three. Will Zediker, and it's good. Ava Zediker with her third three of the night, and she's got 11 points.
Yeah, and they've made it difficult for her tonight, but, you know, the rest of the team has picked her up, and she's just, you know, she's her stats will even out there.
All right, Keen with it, kicks it out to Jayla Williams for three, and it's good. Her Williams was hanging out beyond the three-point arc, left wing, and shoots and scores, and it's 41-18 Dowling. Ellie Olson, or Ellie Moeller, rather, gets it over to Tritton for three, and it's good in the corner. And Moeller gets the assist.
And that was a great call by Tritton over in the corner, calling for the ball when you're open. I know that's something the coaches like to hear. When you're open, present your numbers and call for that ball.
So Tritton now with 5 points all in the fourth quarter. Now a long three. It's no good by Savannah Gage. And the tip up and no good on the missed shot by Ainsley Keene. Rebound Dowling. As the Maroons have in there, Maddie Rice. And now they work it inside. And a shot up and good by the Maroons. And they open up a 46-18 lead.
And their drives are more purposeful this last two and a half quarters, getting in there looking for Moeller to open up.
Whistling a foul on Dowling. And Maddie Rice will pick up the foul. All right, substitutions now for Dowling. Katie Moeller checking in. Sitting down will be Layla Tritton.
We have Coach Jan Jensen here tonight.
She want to talk to you?
No, she wouldn't know. Much like Paul, she wouldn't know who I was.
Inbounds play, and they work it inside to Jayla Williams. Shot off the glass on the right side. Good. Williams with five of her 7 points here in the fourth quarter. 46-20 Dowling. Corner three by Tritton is no good. Offensive rebound Dowling. Maddie Rice saves it and keeps it alive for the Maroons. See if Dowling can get some more in the game. And now Zediker, a backdoor cut, and down the lane, running to the basket with the ball is Ellie Olson shooting the score, and that may be a career high. 10 points for Olson. Wow. Ankeny the other way, and a shot up and good. The basket will count, and a foul on Dowling. Hawkettes hustling down court. Zediker will pick up the foul. That's her first. As the basket by Jayla Williams is good. So Williams now with 9 points and a chance for Nan One. Zediker will check out of the Dowling lineup. Replacing her will be Layla Tritton. So Williams, a 71% free throw shooter on the year, and hits the free throw. Tonight's game on Iowa Catholic Radio brought to you in part by Blessman International, Fast Signs, and Klein Electric. Mark Amadale, Scott Babinet. Dowling with the ball, leading 48-23. 4.5 minutes to go. Fourth quarter here at the Ankeny Gym. Dowling with the lead. And here's Olson for three. It's no good. Ball tipped out of bounds. They say it went off of Dowling and Maddie Rice. Maddie, a 5'8 sophomore, getting in the rotation. I think we've seen Kaylee Klein in there tonight for the Maroons. That's usually one of the other players Coach Meyer will use, along with Macy Harnden, who we have seen tonight here, Scott.
Getting some of these players some rest, being a three-game week. Rest their legs a little bit, especially this lead.
All right, here's the steal by Katie Muller underneath on Ankeny's possession as we're under 4 minutes of play. Tritton in the front court to Harnden. They lob it inside to Ellie Muller. And now weak side help. Ainsley King with the steal by Ankeny. The Hawkets double team Ellie Muller. Now a long three up and no good by the Hawkettes. And now a loose ball foul on Ankeny. And it'll be Dowling possession.
Ellie Muller's done a much better job tonight getting involved on the offensive end. That time she caught it. Good strong position, but turned right in the defender with the ball low. She keeps that high or looks for a cutter. Dowling have a layup there.
Libby Loft is just checking in, a 5'6 junior wearing number 24 with the foul. That is team foul number one on Ankeny here in the fourth quarter. Here's Harnden down the lane. Her shot up and no good. Left it short. Rebound, Ankeny. Hawks with the outlet pass. Ainsley Keene waiting for the rest of her team. Looking for Jax. Gets it to Williams underneath. Her shot no good. Drew the foul. And that'll be on, let's see, will it be on Klein or Rice? It'll be on Rice, her second for Dowling. That'll be the third team foul on the Maroons with Williams going to the free throw line for two. First free throw is good by Jayla Williams.
And again tonight, the Maroons have made it tough for Williams to score in there. She was probably thankful to see Zetica go to the bench a little bit ago.
Second free throw is no good. Williams with 11 points for Ankeny. Rebound Dowling. Approaching the three-minute mark. Maroons leading 48-24 as the Maroons have doubled the score here at the Hawk Gym. A whistle and a foul on Ankeny. I think we're going to get Savannah Gage. That's her first foul, team foul number two on the Hawkettes. Dowling will inbound the ball. They go right to left. Here's Tritton coming off a ball screen by Emma Hazel, who's in there, number 31 for Dowling. Now to Katie Muller. Katie, a crossover dribble on the baseline. Her shot up, no good. Might have been partially blocked. Rebound Ankeny. Williams with it. She pushed the ball up four, down the right side, in the lane. Bounce pass on the left block. They kick it out for three. It's no good. And the rebound, Dowling. Katie Muller with the rebound. Outlet pass to Harnden. She'll launch the three in transition, and it's good. Macy Harnden with her first three of the night. Her 12th of the year.
And it's good to see that coming back into the Maroons game, getting out, getting to their spots, and shooting the shots that they want to shoot.
And getting your shoulders and your feet all, you know, set and ready. Now a long three. Good. By Ainsley Keene. That's her second three of the night. She has 8 points. 51-27, and now the ball inside to Tritton. It's stolen away by Ankeny. There's Carson Jacks dribbling in the front court off the Dowling turnover with a minute 45 to go in the fourth quarter. Maroons have this game well in hand. Couldn't say that at the end of the first quarter. The Hawkettes led 9-6. There's a jumper from the right elbow. No good by Jayla Williams. Rebound Dowling. Harnden with the rebound. Dowling in the lane. Now they kick it back out. Tritton looking for a cutter. Can't get it to Hazel, who's in there. 20 on the shot clock and a whistle and a foul on Ankeny. That'll be on Carson Jacks.
I think it's about as close as we've come this game to possibly getting to the bonus.
On Jax, that'll be her second foul. As Dowling will inbound the ball with a minute 15 to play. Here's Harnden over in the corner. A three-pointer up and good by Maddie Rice. That is her third three of the year. For the 5'8 sophomore, 54-27, Dowling, a minute to play here in the fourth quarter.
Nice kick out, nice quick release to finish that play.
Ankeny with the basketball. There's Schopfeld with it. Get it over in the corner to Anselmi. Top of the key to Schopfeld. Dribbles baseline on the left side. Shot with the left hand, no good over Katie Muller. Rebound Dowling. Harnden leads the break. Right side it goes to Nellie Johnson, who's in there, number 35. 5'7 sophomore to Katie Muller. Muller in the lane with the left hand. Layup good. Katie went through a little bit of traffic to get that done.
It's good to see her becoming aggressive again with her shot, or, you know, now driving. She's a very good three-point shooter, but she needs to use that drive a little bit more, too.
Long three no good by the Hawkettes. And Ainsley Keene rebound Dowling. Shoot, the Maroons will hold it here. 10 seconds to play. 56-27 is our score, and Dowling will dribble it out. And the Maroons will go on and start another winning streak. As the horn sounds, the Dowling girls now improve their record to 11-4. Ankeny Hawkettes fall to 9-7 as Dowling. Kind of a come from behind 56-27 win over the Ankeny Hawkettes here at the Ankeny Gym. We'll take a 2-minute break and come back with our postgame show here on the girls' side alongside Scott Babinet, Mark Amadale. Again, the final in game one. Third-ranked Dowling in Class 5A, a 56-27 winner over number 7 Ankeny here at the Ankeny Gym. We'll take a 2-minute break and come back with our postgame show following these messages here on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network.
This is a Young Catholic Minute.
Why do I have to go to church on Sunday?
Aren't your best friends the ones you only see once in a while? Like after you've gotten to all the really important stuff, or maybe just on Christmas and Easter? I don't think so. But lots of people let their relationship with God go just like that. God invites each of us to a deep relationship with Him. In the time of Christ, when someone invited you to share a meal with them, they were inviting you to be a part of their family. That's what God does in the Mass. And this is no ordinary meal. In the Eucharist, we receive the living body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus. So, if we say no to the invitation to Mass, we're saying, I don't want to be a part of your family. I don't want your sacrifice. I don't want your redemption. And it's pretty hard to have a relationship with God when we've rejected Him so completely. For more Young Catholic Minutes, go to youngcatholicminute.com.
I'm Father Thomas Loya, and this week on Light of the East on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network, St. John Paul II reminded us that the Church breathes with two lungs, East and West, two complementary approaches to the one same faith and same Pope with their own respective styles of expression. But what is it that the two lungs have in common? Light of the East, Sunday mornings at 10:30 on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio comes from Caldwell Parish Funeral Home and Crematory. Caldwell Parish offers services that are unique to the individual while following the Catholic funeral rites. Caldwell Parish Funeral Home and Crematory, Des Moines' only Catholic-owned and operated funeral home.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio comes from Westgate Dental, offering cosmetic, family, implant, and general dentistry. Located at 1073rd Street, Suite 1 in West Des Moines, just behind Dowling Catholic High School. Learn more at westgatedentalia.com.
And we're back here at the Ankeny Gym alongside Scott Babinet, Mark Amadale. A final in game one. Dowling girls, a 56-27 win over the Ankeny Hawkettes. And Scott, what a night it was. Dowling was down 9-6 at the end of the first quarter. They were actually down 9-0 before the Maroons scored the final 6 points the first quarter. And then that kind of helped them propel to that second quarter where they outscored the Hawkettes 15-1 and led at halftime 21-10. But it didn't start out that way.
And the good thing for Dowling is they didn't panic. They let their defense do it. I mean, even giving up 9 points in a quarter is not a bad defensive effort. So they let their defense speak for them, get them back on a roll until the offense caught up. And that was just a good overall, like you said, comeback from being down nine.
Well, you have a look at some of the numbers. I know they're unofficial, but they're official by our standards.
Okay. Well, tonight the Maroons shot 25 for 46 from the field, 6 for 21 from 3, 0 for 1 from the line, 39 rebounds, 9 offensive, and 16 turnovers for the game. For Ankeny, their shooting tonight was 9 for 48 from the field, 3 for 17 from the three-point line, 6 for 9 from the free throw line with 21 rebounds and 9 turnovers.
All right. As take a look at the scoring now for both teams. We'll start off with Dowling. Their leading scorer was Ellie Muller with 16 points tonight. She had 10 at halftime and 6 in the second half for her 16 points. 11 points for Ava Zediker. 10 points for Ellie Olson. That may be a career high. 5 points for Layla Tritton. 4 points for Katie Muller. Off the bench, Maddie Rice and Macy Herndon with 3 points each. Also in there as the Maroons emptied their bench tonight, Nellie Johnson also was in the contest, and so was Emma Hazel, who did not score. Dowling, believe it or not, 0-for-1 at the free throw line. Just one free throw attempt. That changed a little bit for Ankeny. The Hawks were 6-of-9 at the free throw line. That was probably the one big difference in this contest. I'll let you speak to that in a moment here, Scott. But Ankeny held to one player in double figures, and that was Jayla Williams, the 5'10 sophomore with 11 points. She was followed by Ainsley Keene, another sophomore, with eight points. 4 points for Savannah Gage, Carson Jacks with 3 points. And then Kyla Schatfeld off the bench, no points. Maddie Anselme, no points off the bench. Jade Moser came in, no points. Libby Loftus. Cassie Johnson finishing with 1 point. So, again, 6-for-9 at the free throw line was Ankeny tonight, and Dowling 0-for-1. The Maroons persevered through a slow start and a lack of free throws tonight.
Yeah, I think the difference, when you mentioned the free throws, I do think Ankeny was a lot more aggressive going to the basket early on in the game and creating problems when Dowling didn't move their feet. Dowling shot 21 threes, and so they were settling a little bit more. And then when they finally started to get the ball to Ellie Olson inside, they just weren't fouling her. She was just quick with the ball to get up, and they didn't really have anybody to challenge her inside. So that probably explains not getting to the line as much.
Again, Ankeny got out to a 9-0 lead at the end of the first quarter. Dowling scored the final 6 points of the first quarter. It was Ankeny 9-6 at the end of one quarter play. Dowling outscoring Ankeny 15-1 in the second quarter. Maroons led at halftime 21-10. And that defense continued in the third quarter. Dowling outscoring Ankeny 13-5. The Maroons leading 34-15 going into the fourth quarter and outscore the Hawkettes 22-12 in the fourth to win it 56-27. Again, Dowling improves its record to 11-4. And believe it or not, there are just 6 games left in the regular season, and 2 of those are this week with games at Valley and Southeast Polk for both the Dowling girls and boys.
Yeah, it sure is going quickly. I mean, I didn't even realize the state tournament starts in February this year, where it started in March, I think, the last couple of years. But, yeah, it's flying, and then, you know, cramming these games together late to get them in is because of the snow outs is going to just make this thing go really fast.
So we mentioned Dowling's schedule: at number 11 Valley on Thursday, at number 12 Southeast Polk on Friday, and then we'll be back in Ankeny, but to the other school next Monday. One game, it'll be Dowling taking on Ankeny Centennial in girls play. It'll be a top 5 matchup, 5th-ranked Centennial and 3rd-ranked Dowling, and that'll be a 6:15 start next Monday night. It'll be one game, as the Dowling boys are going to elect to make up their Centennial game on a Saturday in February. So a note there. Dowling's largest lead tonight, besides the final score, was really slim at times. They got it up to 23 points at one time. Ankeny's largest lead was 9 points, and that was in the first quarter, and the Maroons overcame a slow start. And I think you said it a lot, Scott, just not getting off to a great start, kind of a slow-developing game, but they turned it on.
Yeah, I mean, Dowling struggled to get into their offense the last couple games, and they're just not getting the shots they want. They're not rebounding and getting out on the break and opening up the shooters on the wings and getting the cutters. But the positive side is that we're starting to see scoring inside by Ellie Olson. And if they can continue to get anywhere from 6 to 10 points from her, that's just going to accentuate the balance of the team and getting everybody else involved.
No question about it. Well, appreciate it, Scott, joining us tonight. And Mr. Babinette, we will talk to you Thursday night.
Sounds good.
And at the Valley Gym, we'll be courtside there too, but maybe closer to the bench.
Right next to Coach Danner.
That's right. Yeah, you guys can share notes. All right, Scott.
To call a timeout.
Appreciate it. Drive careful with the snow, fog, and some of the ice going on right now.
Thank you. See you
All
Thursday.
Right. Scott Babinette, my broadcast partner. That'll wrap up our post-game show for Game 1. Again, the final, Dowling girls defeating Ankeny 56-27 here at the Ankeny Gym. Third-ranked Dowling girls now with the record of 11-4. The seventh-ranked Ankeny girls fall to 9-7. Coming up, Jimmy Cataldo will join us here on Iowa Catholic Radio as we preview the boys' contest between Dowling and Ankeny. And we'll take a one-minute break and return here on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network.
Support for programming comes from Klein Electric, a local family-oriented electrical contractor, a 100% employee-owned company with branches across the Midwest to provide comprehensive electrical services. Klein Electric is able to help with any residential and commercial project. Learn more at KleinElectric.com.
Fast Signs is a custom sign and visual solutions company with an extensive selection of digital signage, interior and exterior signs, banners, and vehicle wraps. Learn more at FastSigns.com. Thank you, Fast Signs in Clive, for your support of Iowa Catholic Radio.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio is provided by Bozen the Florist. Valentine's Day, Mother's Day, weddings, whatever the message, say more with Bozen. Bozen.com, 515-244-ROSE. Bozen makes the moment mean more.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio is provided by Skeffington's Formal Wear. In business since 1951, with locations in Des Moines, West Des Moines, Coralville, and Ankeny. Skeffington's Formal Wear, fitting you for life celebrations. Online at Skeffington's.com.
And welcome back to the Ankeny Gym. That's where we're at tonight. Tuesday night high school girls and boys basketball in the Central Iowa Metro League. Class 5A girls and Class 4A boys. Dowling girls a winner in game one, 56-27 over Ankeny. And now we'll start game two, previewing the boys matchup. And again, a rematch between Dowling and Ankeny earlier in the season. Ankeny outlasted Dowling 79-77, the final game we had. Jimmy Cataldos, we welcome you in right before the Christmas break. Game was in the 70s. The other night it was in the 40s. You know, that's kind of, you get different avenues of basketball. And be interested to see how these teams face each other for the second time, how this turns out. Will the ball game be in the 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s? Who knows?
Well, you know, as a coach, you always like to dictate the tempo of the game. And I think what Coach Einerson and Dowling has found themselves in is you know, running the game that the other teams are playing. And Johnston played a heck of a defensive game on Dowling the other night and held Dowling to 40 points. But just poor shooting by the Maroons, you know, altogether. And I think that was their Achilles heel. And, you know, listen to Coach Einerson during his halftime interview. You know, it was shocking when he said that they were 1 of 15 from around the rim the other night against Johnston. And then, you know, you got to convert, you got to finish. So it's going to be a key tonight to see how the Maroons finish around the rim, especially with the presence of Leo Aguirre, who I thought played a tremendous game against the Maroons the first time around.
Yeah, he was, you know, he had his way. I know different. Ankeny had a well-balanced team game against Dowling the first time, and you look at the numbers. Leo Aguirre, who you mentioned, finished with 17 points. He and Carson Johnson, who finished with 24, were kind of the backbreakers, but you bring in their quarterback off the bench, Luke Anderson. He had a nice game, 11 points off the bench, knocked down three threes, and every time Dowling seemed to get something going, Anderson had a big shot off the bench to curb that, and the Maroons end up losing by two, but Dowling did a lot of good things in that contest.
Well, Ankeny is one of the best offensive scoring teams in Class 4A. They're number six in points scored, they're number three in field goal percentage, and they're number one in three-point shooting percentage. So you better be able to guard the three-point shot when you play Ankeny, especially at home tonight. That's going to be a key for the Maroons on how well they're going to defend, you know, one of the top-scoring teams in Class 4A.
Other games going on tonight has Valley at Johnson. These are all girl-boy doubleheaders. Ankeny Centennial at Waukee, Southeast Polk at Urbandale. And in a boys' matchup, Grandview Christian at Waukee Northwest. The Waukee Northwest girls have the night off. Well, Jimmy, as you look at Dowling, the Maroons have got into their rotation, but, you know, struggle to be consistent. I think that's the key to any program. Maroons come in with a record of 6-6. Ankeny at 9-4. The Hawks are ranked ninth in the latest poll that came out. Matter of fact, there are four CIML teams in the top 10 in the Class 4A poll that came out yesterday. Waukee at third is third. Valley falls from second to fourth. Ankeny Centennial is fifth, and the Ankeny Hawks, who Dowling plays tonight here at the Ankeny Gym, is at number nine.
girls basketball coaches are all excited tonight.
Well, this is like a welcome center. Your grandma and grandpa are at the top row. Yeah, we just been waving people through. That's how we do it.
I forgot that everybody who shows up there has to give you a fist bump just to let them know, hey, nice to see you, Mark, in the middle of your broadcast, so it's fun.
That's how it works. That's why we're – and if listeners may be a little late to the game, the TV people got the upper – you see Mr. Yeager up there? He got – They got the upper deck. So we're down here on the baseline, right outside the Dowling bench where we were a year ago.
Yes.
We have not upgraded or been degraded. And I want to thank Mike Baker. Actually, he just started becoming the athletic director here January 1st. And Mike's been at the middle school for many years, and now he's elevated. And I said, hey, prime time right here.
No, but you look at tonight's game and you look at what you're talking about for the Maroons, I think – offensively, they've just been struggling from the three-point shot. They have guys who can knock down threes. It just sometimes they settle for that shot way too early in the offensive set. So, hopefully the Maroons find themselves, knocking down some shots, but, getting to the free throw line. I thought it was also interesting Coach Einertsen talking about getting to the free throw line more times than you attempt threes. I think that was the key for him. And,
yes.
And let's see if that comes to fruition tonight.
All right, we're going to take a one-minute break, come back with starting lineups between Dowling and Ankeny, the boys' contest. Here at the Ankeny Gym. Earlier tonight, the Dowling girls, a winner over Ankeny, 56-27. And alongside Jimmy Cataldo, I'm Mark Amadale. Will we take a one-minute break and come back with the starting lineups, boys action, Dowling and Ankeny here at the Ankeny Gym on Iowa Catholic Radio.
Iowa Catholic Radio is supported by our listeners and business underwriters as we connect listeners to Christ while bridging the gap between the church and the marketplace, seeking God in both. If you own a business that you'd like to use to help further this mission, email deaconmark@iowacatholicradio.com. And we encourage you to thank the many businesses who choose to underwrite programming on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network. Your presence is vital as we participate in the church and the marketplace, seeking God in both.
Brightside Aesthetics by Ducharme Dermatology provides advanced and medical aesthetics, body contouring, wellness, and spa services. Learn more at brightsideiowa.com. Thank you, Brightside Aesthetics, for your support of Iowa Catholic Radio.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio comes from Mercy One. We all want to live our best life. That's why Mercy One offers compassionate, personalized care when and where you need it. Schedule online at mercyone.org.
Hey, we're back here at the Ankeny Gym, ready for game two of our girl-boy doubleheader. Dowling and Ankeny, and the first of three road games this week for both the Dowling girls and boys basketball teams. We'll be back on the air Thursday night as Dowling makes up their game with Valley, and we'll be at the Valley Gym courtside. And then Friday, we end up at Southeast Polk High School. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. First of all, for Dowling, they'll go with their usual starting lineup that they've had since Christmas break at one guard, the point guard, Joey Coppola, 5'11 senior. Leading scorer for the Maroons, averaging 14 points. They were number four. The other guard is Maddox Coppola, his younger brother, a 6'1 sophomore, averaging just under 4 points. They were number 13. At one forward, Ryan Kleppe, a 6'3 senior, averaging just under 10 points, wearing number 12. And the other forward, Riddick Metten for Dowling, a 6'3 senior, averaging 13 points. They were number 21. And at center, Mr. Double-Double, Joe Broderick, averaging 13 points, 12.5 rebounds. Joe is a 6'4 senior, and he'll wear number 10. So Coppola, Kleppe, Metten, and Broderick. Dowling coached by Justin Einertsen in his first year, 6 wins, 6 losses, 8th year overall, assisted by Jimmy Nahas, Zach Nicholson, Kevin O'Hare, and John Nagel. Maroons average 59 points on offense, give up 57.5 points on defense. And now for the Ankeny Hawks. Under 8th-year coach Brant Carlson, they were state champs back in 2020, 100 wins and 75 losses. He's assisted by Jamie Montgomery, might remember that name, Johnny Orr's grandson, Lincoln Conry, and Luke Parkinson. And they will start Ankeny Will, Cash Shewan, a 6'4 senior at one guard, Carson Johnson the other. Leo Aguirre and his brother Rio Aguirre at forward, and Cade Peterson at center, a 6'6 senior. Underway, Dowling going left to right, and Ankeny wins the tip. Dowling gets a steal on Ankeny's first possession. Maroons in their road. Maroon uniforms with black numbers and trim. Ankeny with their home white uniforms with maroon numbers and gold trim. And now Down the right side, a shot in the lane. Rolls off the rim. No good in the first shot of the night by Dowling. Rebound, Ankeny. And the Hawks the other way.
Good strong take by Metten on that. And you know, doesn't manipulate his shot. Goes up strong. Just rolls off the rim. But a good shot early.
All right, Ankeny with the ball. 20 on the shot clock. Now Aguirre has a ball go off his foot, and it'll be Dowling basketball. Good hustle defense that time by Dowling. They got Leo Aguirre with the turnover.
But you can already see that, you know, the limitations that we have down here on the baseline. You know, we're getting blocked out by coaching staff standing up.
I never heard the guy that was with me earlier, Mr. Babinet, say one word about the crowd that we sometimes get. Never heard a negative thing. We just persevere. Here's Broderick on the baseline. His shot's no good. And the rebound out to Ankeny. Runs a one and done. Here's Carson Johnson with it. And who's got him? Riddick Metten has him first. There's Rio Aguirre. Pulls up three in front of us. Up and no good. Loses his legs, but rebound Dowling and Kleppy.
Good defense on that by Joe Coppola, getting the hand in Aguirre's face and contesting the three-point shot, which, like I said, they lead the state in Class 4A in three-point percentage. So good job getting the hand in their face and contesting the shot.
There's Broderick. Good defense by Ankeny. So over to Metten. Riddick on the right block, guarded by Aguirre. Shot off the glass. Good. Nice, smooth shot with a soft touch by Riddick Metten. And it's 2-0 Dowling.
Dowling's going back to their zone press and just letting Ankeny slow down the tempo a little bit.
Carson Johnson with it. Hands it off to Schoolin. Back out to Johnson. Carson leads the team just under 24 points per game. Leads the team in assist too, with just over three a contest. 10 on the shot clock. This is Aguirre. That's Leo with it. Gets it to his brother Rio. Now to Peterson. Peterson a baseline pass. Shot up and no good by Schoolin. Nearly violated the shot clock. And Dowling gets the rebound. The other way we go. Maroons lead it 2-0 here in the first quarter at the Ankeny Gym. To join us late, Dowling girls a winner 56-27 in game one. Now Dowling against man-to-man defense. Here's Coppola with it. Little backdoor cut and a whistle and a foul as a little give and go to Metten, and Metten drew the foul.
Foul on Leo Aguirre, his first of the game. Or Rio Aguirre.
Yeah, Rio number 35. Dowling inbounds the ball. Metten shot top of the key. It's no good, and a rebound cleared out of there by Cade Peterson, their 6'6 senior for the Hawks. Leads the team with 11 blocks. In transition, three-pointer no good by Aguirre, and that's Rio with the miss. Rebound Dowling and Broderick. So lid on the basket thus far for Ankeny. Metten down the lane. Goes through contact. Puts up the shot. Good. Nice move by Riddick Metten. He had played right off that contact there, Jimmy, in the lane.
Well, he's done a great job taking the ball right at Leo Aguirre and going hard to the basket on at least three possessions we've seen. So Riddick's really good and strong, aggressive to the basket, which has been very, very positive for him so far with 4 points.
All right, here's Carson Johnson. Fadeaway jumper, good from the left elbow right over Maddox Coppola. Carson Johnson with his first two of the night. He torched Dowling for 24 last time. Now reverse layup, no good by Joey Coppola. Offensive rebound, Broderick. Reverse layup is no good. And rebound, Ankeny. He's had two shots there. Here's Schoolin. Hands it off to Carson Johnson. Carson guarded by Metten. Underneath, his shot off, no good. Bodies hit the floor. Rebound, Dowling and Coppola. This is Maddox with it. Out to his brother, who tries to get underneath to Broderick. It's deflected off of him to Kleppy for three. It's no good. And the rebound out to Ankeny. Teams have had some pretty good looks here in this first quarter. Here's Leo Aguirre with it. Guarded by Coppola. It's about to Rio Aguirre. Backs in at the free throw line to Carson Johnson. Maddox Coppola has the first assignment on Johnson. Underneath Aguirre, his shot partially blocked, no good. Rebound Metten. Ball taken away from him by Schoolin. His shot up and good. Cash Schoolin battling in there and stole away from Metten and scores. Tied at four.
So, I mean, so many bodies going hard for that rebound, and Metten just gets a little bit loose.
Now Coppola gets underneath. His shot is blocked by Peterson. Down court is Schoolin. Layup is good. Nice run out that time by Ankeny. Set up by the block shot by Schoolin. 6-4 Hawks. Their first lead of the night. He's dialing with it, top of the key, Kleppe. Guarded by Rio Aguirre. And all along three by Coppola is no good. Fight for the rebound. And coming away with it is Cade Peterson. As he out-dueled Broderick there on that rebound.
Making shots is going to be critical for the Maroons because it allows them to set up their press and slow down Ankeny's offense a little bit. So missed shots, not getting that defense set.
Here's Maddox Coppola. Pull-up jumper, no good. Good defense that time by Maddox Coppola on him. Rebound Dowling. Here's Metten with it to Joey Coppola. Joey, a head fake. Jump stop. Kicks it out to Kleppe. He'll launch the three. Top of the key. It's off the mark. No good. Rebound Cash Schoolen and the Hawks. 6-4.
Talked about the three-point shot. Critical for the Maroons to knock some of those down right now. 0-for-4 right now in the first quarter. Got to knock down those three-point shots or don't settle for them. Work the ball to the basket.
6-4 Ankeny, and now down the lane, Cash Schoolen shoots and scores, and he's fouled. And I think they're going to count the basket, and they will. Fouls on Dowling, and that'll be on Riddick Metten, his first. And it'll be an and-one coming for Cash Schoolen, who has 6 points here in the first quarter, 8-4. Ankeny, third largest lead. Dowling jumped out to a 2-0 lead, and Ankeny has tied it. The free throw's good. 7 points for Schoolen, and that's his average. 2:07 remaining first quarter. The Hawks now with a 5-point lead over Dowling, 9-4. Joey Coppola, Ryan Kleppe, Joe Broderick, along with Dante Cataldo, who's in there. Now, here's Kleppe off the glass. His shot up and good. Dante Cataldo and Cole Southern check in for the Maroons.
Nick Frerichs checked in for Joey Coppola as well. So three new Maroons.
Three guards come in, and now whistling a foul on Dowling the other way with Ankeny. They're going to get Southern with his first foul. A nice move that time in the lane by Ryan Kleppe. Lefty right off the glass.
Well, we didn't see much of Ryan, at least in the early part of the first quarter.
Now the inbound, the ball to Carson Johnson. Underneath he goes, layup is good. Carson Johnson, strong move, went right around Dante for the basket. His fourth point, 11-6, Ankeny by five. Frerichs gets the Kleppe for three, good! Ryan Kleppe with 5 points. That's his 15th three of the year. Dowling with a little full court press here, Jimmy, 2-2-1.
Made basket again, allows the Maroons to get into this and slow Ankeny down a little bit.
Now the Hawks with a corner three, good by Rio Aguirre. 14-9, Ankeny, Dowling the other way. Here's Frerichs with it. Hands it off to Broderick at the free throw line for his shot, no good. And a rebound, Ankeny. Hawks with it as Nolan Dalton, number 23 in the lineup for Ankeny. And they work underneath. A shot up and good by Carson Johnson. The basket will count. Foul on Dowling. And the Hawks find a way to get to the basket. They're going to get Frerichs for the foul.
Carson Johnson just so tough penetrating to the basket. And hard to guard unless you're getting some help from underneath. And then if you help, it's a double-edged sword where you leave your guy at the block and open that up. So guards for the Maroons just got to play a little bit better, squaring up on Carson Johnson, taking away the dribble drive.
Johnson with 6 points and the free throw good. He now has 7 points, so he and Schoolen with 7 points each for Ankeny. And the Hawks now open up an 8-point lead, 17-9 over Dowling. Final 45 seconds of the first quarter. Joe Broderick dribbles baseline, kicks it out to Cataldo. Now Joey Coppola back in the lineup along with his brother Maddox Coppola. Now here's Cataldo with it in the lane. His shot up, left it short, and rebound Ankeny. Coming away with it is Luke Anderson. Got a pair of quarterbacks in there now, your son and Mr. Anderson. Now the Hawks are, let's see, shot clock is off, 15 seconds remaining in the quarter. Ankeny with its largest lead of 8, 17-9. Carson Johnson now guarded by Maddox Coppola. Now good job by Maddox, and now he almost forced a turnover. And Maddox may have been shaken up on the play as he hit the deck and slow to get up with 2 seconds remaining.
Just a little bit of the wind knocked out of him, it looks like.
Riddick Metten will replace him. So Metten, Kleppe, Cataldo, Broderick, in the Dowling lineup, along with Joey Coppola, who will guard the inbounds pass, and that would be Luke Anderson throwing it in. Gets it to Aguirre. This is Rio at the horn. It's good. They'll count the basket by Rio Aguirre. And we go to half, or we go at the end of the first quarter with the score. Ankeny 20, Dowling 9, alongside Jimmy Cataldo, Mark Amadale. Back after this one-minute break. We'll be back for the second quarter on Iowa Catholic Radio.
This is a Young Catholic Minute.
How can I speak up without shutting people down?
Boy, this one is pretty easy to answer, but really hard to do. The easy part of the answer is that every human being is made to love truth. And so when you share it lovingly, calling them on to something greater that will give them happiness and freedom, that is, as the Bible says, good news of great joy. Unfortunately, we humans have a terrible tendency to do the right things for all the wrong reasons. So if we're sharing the truth just because we know we're right, or we want to win an argument, or want to chalk one up on the old soul-saving tally, we're not really trying to give the gift of Christ's love, so we're using the truth to lie, and that won't inspire anyone. On the other hand, remember that Jesus lived and spoke the truth perfectly, and some people still didn't believe. So if that happens to you, offer your sufferings to Christ and pray for the grace to get up again. For more Young Catholic Minutes, go to youngcatholicminute.com.
And we're back here at the Ankeny Gym, underway in the second quarter. Dowling will have the basketball first. It's Ankeny 20, Dowling 9. Now on the first possession, a bad pass. The ball goes out of bounds. It'll be Hawk basketball as that last bucket of the quarter by Rio Aguirre. They counted it as a three at the horn. And the Hawks with their largest lead of 11 here, Jimmy.
There's just that miscommunication on the turnover there. And you know, you got to take advantage of every opportunity or every possession you get, and can't give Ankeny any additional possessions on turnovers, especially not tonight.
Here's Carson Johnson, pull-up jumper. It's no good. Rebound Dowling and Maddox Coppola. Maddox now with the basketball, dribbles in the front court, passes on the right side. That's Riddick Metten, spins in the right block, shot over Aguirre, good. Dowling is getting that shot. And Riddick with his 6 point. We've seen Kleppy do the same on the other side. 20-11. Ankeny by 9. Earlier tonight, if you joined us late, Dowling girls a winner, 56-27 over Ankeny in game one of our girl-boy doubleheader. Hawks with the basketball, 15 on the shot clock. Underneath the gear, and he draws the foul. Let's see if they're going to whistle this on Broderick. Nope. They're going to get it on. Yeah, they will get it on Joe. That's his first. And they reset the shot, reset the fouls. That'll be the first team foul on Dowling here in the second quarter, Jimmy.
Oh, Gary is just so strong and strong football player as he is, and really pushing his way into the middle of the in the middle of the lane. Just not converting on the and one.
Second free throw by the left-hander, good. Oh, no good, excuse me. Rebound Ankeny, and Anderson comes away with it. Now stolen away by Joey Coppola, and a bad pass by the Hawks. 20-11. Coppola gets it underneath, and a layup up and good as he found Kleppy on a no-look pass, I believe.
Maroons are really making their hay inside the paint there. Now they're six of 10 from inside the paint and just one of six from three-point range. So getting to the basket is bode well for the Maroons.
Now here's a strong move by Rio Aguirre, the 6'1 sophomore, dribbles baseline, takes it in and scores. So Rio with his 8 point. 22-13, now a steal by Carson Johnson, and his layup is good. And timeout Dowling. So Carson Johnson, a steal in basket, he's got 9 points. And this will be a 30-second timeout called by Dowling. 24-13, the Ankeny lead is 11. Tonight's game on Iowa Catholic Radio brought to you in part by our good friends at Construction Professionals, Klein Electric, and the Catholic Tuition Organization. Mark Amadale alongside Jimmy Cataldo. And Jimmy, go ahead with those first quarter numbers.
First quarter numbers for the Maroons, shot 5 of 14 from the field. As I mentioned, 1 of 6 from 3. The six total rebounds, just one turnover for the Ankeny Hawks, 8 of 14 from the field, which is 2 of 3 from threes. They had 10 rebounds and 2 turnovers, so they did out-rebound the Maroons 10 to 6 in the first quarter and definitely outshot them making, what, two of three, number one shooting three-point percentage team in Class 4A, continuing the hot shooting.
Tonight's officials, Mark Flegel, Matt Roberts, and Dan Beating, as they stuck around from the girls' game. Dowling with the ball out of the timeout. He's now in the lane as Maddox Coppola, pull-up jumper good. They isolated Maddox, and he got the shot to fall. That's his first 2 points tonight. 24-15, the Ankeny lead is now nine. Dowling with the press. Now the ball goes off the foot of Schoolin, out of bounds. It'll be Dowling basketball. So that press bothered the Hawks a little bit. They did break it, but pass down low into Schoolin, deflected off his foot. And there's Coppola, and this is Joey Coppola bringing it up for Dowling. Joey gets all the way to the right block, kicks it out to Metten. Three-pointer top of the key, rolls around the rim and scores. Riddick met with his first three, and he's got 9 points. And the Maroons now have cut it to six, 24-18. Ankeny over Dowling here in this boys' contest. But the basketball is Leo Aguirre. Pull-up jumper right baseline, no good. All of a sudden, Ankeny's went cold. Rebound Dowling. Here's Coppola with it. Gets it to Metten as they fill the lane. Pull-up jumper, three-pointer no good by Maddox Coppola. Rebound Leo Aguirre. Ankeny the other way. This is Cash Schoolin. It's a two. Rio Aguirre, he goes inside. A layup is good. They let him through. And Rio with his 10th point. And Dowling the other way. Kleppy shoots and scores. And Dowling, when they can get inside, they've been pretty dangerous.
See, this is where it slows Ankeny down. And even though the press isn't inducing many turnovers, it's getting them out of their rhythm a little bit. And that's what the Maroons are looking to do on their defensive side.
Here's Carson Johnson, guarded by Maddox Coppola. Johnson double team. Pull-up jumper, left it short. And a rebound Dowling and Riddick Metten. We got a great view of the Dowling rebounding underneath this basket here in this first half. Now a long three by Joey Coppola. It's no good. Offensive rebound, Metten. Let's keep the ball alive. Riddick underneath. His shot up, left it short. Rebound, Leo Aguirre. And here's Ankeny with the ball with 4:10 to go in the quarter, rather in the first half. And now underneath, Leo Aguirre with the assist as Cade Peterson shoots and scores in transition. Justin, the Maroons put on a little run. Ankeny comes back and answers with the back-to-back baskets. Here's Metten for three. It's no good. From the right wing, rebound Ankeny and Cade Peterson with 3:45 to go. Hawks lead by eight. Dowling stays man-to-man. They back off the press. Here's Rio Aguirre. Gets it in the high post to his brother Leo between the circles. Out to Rio Aguirre. Cross-court pass to Carson Johnson. Carson guarded by Coppola. Dribbles to the right elbow. Pull-up jumper up and off the rim and good. The basket will count. A foul on Joey Coppola. He's been a matchup problem all night. We've had several Dowling players guard him, or at least try to, and Carson will have an and one here as substitutions in the lineup.
Just a good, strong first step by Carson Johnson. Just really gets the defender off balance a little bit, and then to be able to control yourself through contact and put up a six-foot jump shot is you know, pretty talented.
On Joey Coppola, that's his first foul. 30-20, Ankeny by 10. And the free throw is good by Carson Johnson, an 89% free throw shooter on the year. The Hawks now 3-for-3 tonight at the free throw line. Dowling has yet to attempt the free throw. Kleppy for three, top of the key, no good, as Ali Eric Agal checks into the Dowling lineup, number 33. Kleppy's three, no good, and now dribbling off his foot is Rio Aguirre, and he turns it over, so it'll be Dowling basketball. So it's Kleppy, Agal, Maddox, and Joey Coppola.
Lucas Paoli
and that's the other one. 15 is Paoli. Thank you. Maroons with the basketball. Here is Joey Coppola. Dribbles baseline. Reverse layup. Good. He went right around Nolan Dalton, who was guarding him, and Joey with his first basket of the night cuts the lead to 9, 31-22. Ankeny with the ball and the lead. Carson Johnson guarded by Joey Coppola, and we got a reach-in foul on Maddox Coppola. So Maddox with his first foul. Team foul number 3 on Dowling.
The Maroons have yet to get to the free throw line tonight. One of the keys that we had talked about, you know, get into the free throw line more times than you're shooting threes. Well, right now you've shot 11 three-pointers.
Ooh. That's just what Coach was talking about, trying to get more free throws and attempted threes. And now Leo Aguirre kicks the ball back out. Here's Nolan Dalton for 3. It's no good. Met with the rebound, and Dowling now with the basketball, trailing by 9 with 2 minutes to play. Metten underneath, and his shot off the glass too strong, gets his own rebound, put back up and good as he went right around Rio Aguirre. Riddick with 11 points.
Riddick following his shot on the first miss and getting his own rebound, putting it back in, and that's what you teach kids is follow your shot, get the rebound, look for that second attempt.
Now Joey Coppola near steal. The pass goes to Carson Johnson finally. Hawks with it, 18 on the shot clock. Leo Aguirre spins in the lane. Now gets it back out. Out top. As the Hawks now run their offense with 10. Aguirre for 3. Good. Leo with his first 3 of the night. His 11th of the year. It's 34-24. Ankeny by 10. Dowling now with a 3 of its own. Good. That was Maddox Coppola for 3. That's his 5th point.
Paoli,
excuse me. Thank you. Lucas Paoli, the 6-foot junior, cuts the lead to 7, 34-27. Final minute here, Jimmy. Ali Aragao. We haven't seen nothing in the paint since Ali Aragao's been in there, just FYI. Here's Aguirre for 3. It's no good. And rebounded by Aguirre. His shot up and no good. But hustled by Leo as the Maroons did not box him out, and he got another opportunity. Falls on Coppola.
Not sure who was guarding Leo at that time, but 3-point shot, to your point, doesn't block him out. And really, there was a huge space between the basket and Leo to be able to get that front end rebound.
Leo's first free throw, no good. Tonight's game on Iowa Catholic Radio brought to you in part by Boson the Florist, Ashworth Vision Clinic. Our thanks to Blessman International and Fast Signs for supporting our broadcast here on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network of Dowling Catholic Girls and Boys Basketball, our 47th year of covering Dowling sports. Second free throw is good by Leo Aguirre. That's his 4th point of the night. 42 seconds remaining. Ryan Kleppe checking in for Dowling. And Mattis Coppola will sit down. So it'll be Kleppe, Metten, Coppola. And it looks like Broderick's back in there this time. And the Maroons get it into they get it into Metten on the right block. And guess who pushes him off the block is Aguirre, and he'll draw the foul. That'll be Leal's first.
Just strength. Yeah.
Well, Leal was looking to play college football. Last report, NAIA offers, as he was one of the linebackers for this Ankeny Hawk team that went to state, knocked off Dowling in the quarterfinals. All right, shot clock turned off, 18 seconds remaining between the circles. Runes with the basketball. This is Joey Coppola, who's guarded by Cash Schoolin. 8 on the clock. Corner 3 by Metten. Up, good. Smooth shot for Riddick Metten. He's got 14 points.
What a huge basket to end the first quarter.
Wow.
Not really shooting all that great and not getting to the free throw line at all. And that 3-point shot knocks this lead down to 5. So you got to feel a little bit better about yourself going into the halftime. But certainly talking to your kids about, you know, where are we making our bank, and it's been in the lane. Penetrating to the basket, getting to the lane is where we're making our points. And these timely 3-point shots, if they can knock them down, it allows them to set up their press, which we talked is really causing a little bit of fits and out of rhythm to Ankeny.
Ankeny outscored Dowling 20-9 in the first quarter. The Maroons outscoring Ankeny 21-15 in the second quarter. We go to halftime. The Hawk lead is 5, 35-30 over Dowling. Alongside Jimmy Cataldo, Mark Amadale will catch up with members of the Dowling girls program as Coach Kristen Myers will join us here courtside here at the Ankeny Gym. Earlier tonight, the Dowling girls, a 56-27 win over Ankeny. And at halftime of the boys' contest, Ankeny leads Dowling 35-30, and we'll return after this one-minute break here on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio is provided by Ashworth Vision Clinic. Complete eye exams, contact lenses, glasses, glaucoma testing, and urgent eye issues. 515-440-4610, ashworthvision.com.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio comes from the Catholic Tuition Organization. Reduce or eliminate your Iowa income tax and instead give to the Catholic Tuition Organization and receive 75% Iowa tax credits. These tax credits are going fast, so reserve yours today and learn more about the Catholic Tuition Organization at ctoiowa.org. ctoiowa.org. The bottom line, it's for the kids and their futures.
Catholic Tuition Organization, a great investment in our kids.
Support for programming is provided by Construction Professionals, serving customers through a proven process, creating unique design, functionality, and artistic beauty. Construction Professionals is a Catholic family business built on a strong foundation. CPCustomHomes.com.
Three-pointers are close.
And we're back here at the Ankeny Gym alongside Jimmy Cataldo, Mark Amadale. Halftime of the boys' contest. Ankeny leads Dowling 35-30. Joined now by Kristen Meyer, the Dowling girls' head basketball coach, and
Ellie Olson,
the scoring machine. Double figures tonight for Ellie, but
was she?
Yeah, I had her for.
I was thinking eight, but maybe it was 10.
I got her for 10.
I'll take the higher number.
We'll take 10.
She likes.
We'll
my,
see what Huddle stats
likes
say.
My yeah. numbers. Let's see. Ellie Olson, 10 points.
Okay.
Right there, highlighted in yellow.
I like it.
Congratulations, ladies, on the win.
Thank you.
And it was a slow start. 9-0.
That is a nice way to put it.
Yeah.
Slow start.
This kind of reminded me of Pleasant Valley over at Johnson before Christmas.
Yeah, we don't need to go back to that.
I'll get out of that.
Ollie's in charge of making sure we don't.
Who's in charge of the slow starts?
I'm blaming Ollie because she's sitting
I'll
here.
I'll tell you.
No. This young lady was all over the place. Yeah, she scored
steals?
10 points. Steals.
Assists.
Deflections. Assists. Hustle.
Yeah.
Did you see the play down here where she saved the ball right into Tritton layup?
Oh, it was beautiful.
I'm going to have to rewatch that because I don't even know how that worked.
Now, how many times you work on that in practice, Miss Olson?
Can't say a lot, but it's perfected, obviously.
Yeah, we spent 20 obviously. Minutes a day just on that.
Well, Coach Meyer, I know it's coming off a loss on Friday night, bounce back, but now you're on the road. You're going to be the road team the next four games that I know of.
Yeah.
I may lose count, but talk about coming out here and playing Ankeny for the second time. They were struggling. They're coming off a bad loss at Southeast Polk, and they got off to a great start, and it's like, oh, boy, maybe they've found things. But you guys took it away from them in the second quarter, outscored them 21-10. 15-1.
15-1, yeah.
And led 21-10 at halftime. Things changed in the second quarter.
Yeah, it's a good thing things changed. Otherwise, that halftime would have been a little bit feisty. But, we came out a little bit slow. But, I mean, credit Ankeny. They came out ready to go. They were pressuring us, moving the ball on offense, kind of getting us out of our rhythm when we were on offense. But once we settled down and found a couple baskets, only got a couple buckets, Ellie Muller did a fantastic job around the rim and rebounding. Then we kind of got into our groove, and I thought defensively, after the first couple minutes, we played a really good game defensively.
Well, you held their two leading scorers, Carson Jack, Savannah Gage, to single digits. I think it was in the second half before they scored. Jayla Williams, a very talented young lady, had double figures. Ellie Olson, who are you responsible for here in this mixture?
I had Carson, so... How many? Three? Yeah, I had Carson.
Held her to 3 points, one field goal and a free throw.
We'll take it.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, she had Tanky on Friday.
Let's talk about this gal. Last time you had her on, I says, you know, Ellie, could you shoot a little bit more? I prayed on it a little bit, too.
So it must be you are the reason.
Yeah.
All right, thanks, Mark.
Sure.
We appreciate
it. I'm sure. So what's the trick? What happened in the last few weeks? Was it last month I did that?
I don't know. Something like that.
What happened? What's going on with you?
I just think it's like confidence, knowing that I know I can hit those shots, but I also know my teammates believe in me and my coaches believe in me. But then also just getting those openings to create kind of those shots for me and helping my teammates to create their shots.
Well, the way you play your offense, you know, sometimes you work the two-person game on one side. You're effective there. But, you know what, the one thing I don't see, free throws. I don't see any free throws here. We got to get to the free throw line.
Yeah.
That's our next goal.
Okay.
For her or for our team?
No, for her.
I don't think we shot many of them.
We shot one.
Katie?
Just one?
I think Katie with the and one.
Katie? Yeah. Katie with an and one, yeah. And she missed it. So, free throws. I think Ankeny had what? I had them unofficially, six out of nine.
Okay. Yeah, we were scoring in transition, so we didn't drive as much because we were just kind of moving the ball around and hit Ellie a few times.
Yeah.
Both Ellies.
Ellie did an amazing job posting up.
This is with Coach Kristen Myers and Ellie Olson tonight here at halftime of the boys game, 35-30. Dowling trailing Ankeny in the boys contest. What was the game plan tonight, taking on Ankeny for the second time? And, you know, their first-year head coach, Nate Toby, coming off a loss to Southeast Polk. Coach, what are some of the things that's changed since you played him back in December?
Well, in December, they played us a little more zone. So we came in thinking they were going to play man, but also thought they might go to a zone. They might press a little bit, which we didn't see tonight. And so offensively, we were prepared for offense. We knew they might, you know, keep Ole's defender in the lane, so we could mix things up. Sometimes Ole cuts down low. But defensively, they've got four scorers, you know, that do a lot of their work and try to just contain them. Ole helped some in the lane, and I thought we did a pretty good job getting out on shooters, having a hand up, but also kind of closing off drives so they couldn't get to the rim very easily.
Well, quick turnaround. You have tomorrow for practice. And Ellie, you got to love this. A game on Thursday. No practice Thursday, but a game at Valley and then at Southeast Polk, a couple of ranked teams. So what a challenge you have this week for those three CIMO
teams. But it'll be good. It'll be good for us.
Now, Valley got Dowling. First time you played him back in November, right?
Yeah.
That's the first time. Talk about the game plan going to Valley on Thursday night.
Yeah, so it's at Valley, and I don't know. I feel like we're just looking for revenge almost. Like we're kind of almost – we know what we're capable of, but we also know what they're capable of.
Sure.
So just going in, knowing our game plan and sticking to it, making sure we're doing our pace, our stuff, but then – on the defensive side, getting those rebounds and getting stops.
And making the other team uncomfortable, Coach Myers. And that's, you guys have done a pretty good job of that. And this group is hung right in there no matter who you played.
Yeah, I think defensively we are really, really solid. Rebounding, we're really good. We got to do, you know, a few things offensively to cut down on turnovers and shoot a little higher percentage. But we're trending in the right direction.
You know, you play a team twice when you play conference, you know, home and away, obviously. What's some of the things you look at the second time around? Now you're playing Valley for the second time, but what's changed with them since you played them in November?
Yeah, I need to watch a little more film. It's tough because you watch your own film to see kind of their game plan for you, but then you watch their most recent games to see what they want to do recently. And tonight they play Johnston. I haven't checked any scores yet, so we'll watch that. I've already watched, you know, our game. I watched a few games because we were supposed to play Valley a couple weeks ago.
Right.
So we have the scout report, we have the plan, but we might adjust it a little bit based on what they're doing recently. They like to play some zone, some man. To be honest, I think we gave up 54-55 points when we played them in November, and we better not let that happen again. I think our defense is a little bit tighter, and then offensively we'll find some ways to score.
All right, well, I'm glad you brought one of the leading scorers up here. Ellie Olson, double figures with 10 points on my books. I don't know what Kevin Hottie had.
I'll take your book.
But congratulations, Ellie,
on the
win. It's hard to believe you're a junior because I remember you coming up here. Anybody want to give out a shout-out to out there in Olson land?
I don't know. Just my teammates, I would say.
Okay. Well, that's fair.
Don't know who else.
You know, everybody okay in Olwine? I mean, they didn't have an ice storm or anything like that, did they?
Well, my dad texted me. He said, a little bit of a slow start. Like, yes, Dad. Way to state the obvious.
So when I piled on, I can see why she said, you're going to have a tough practice tomorrow.
Yeah.
It'll be good.
Yeah.
As long as we have a good finish,
that's right.
We can overcome a slow start. Mm-hmm. But
well, ladies, thanks for joining us. We'll see you courtside over at the Valley Gym on on Thursday night.
Two nights.
And then, of course, on Friday at Southeast Polk. Mm-hmm. So best of luck. Stay healthy. Recover.
Of course.
And have a good practice tomorrow.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks, Mark.
Ellie Olson and Kristen Meyer joining me at halftime. Halftime score, Ankeny 35, Dowling 30, alongside Jimmy Cataldo, Mark Amadale. We'll return after this one-minute break with the start of the second half in the boys' contest here on Iowa Catholic Radio.
Support for programming funded by Blessman International. We bring the good news of the gospel to South African children and their families through faith formation and locally sustainable programs. As the Fellowship of Christian Athletes location for all South Africa, our Sports for Christ complex provides student access to friendly competition where discipline and dedication are developed. Learn how you can support programs like Sports for Christ or experience the hands-on engagement of a mission trip at blessmaninternational.org.
Fast Signs is a custom sign and visual solutions company with an extensive selection of digital signage, interior and exterior signs, banners, and vehicle wraps. Learn more at fastsigns.com. Thank you, Fast Signs in Clive, for your support of Iowa Catholic Radio.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio is provided by Boson the Florist. Valentine's Day, Mother's Day, weddings, whatever the message, say more with Boson. Boson.com, 515-244-ROSE. Boson makes the moment mean more.
And we're back here at the Ankeny Gym, underway in the second half. Ankeny leads 35-30 in this boys' contest. And Carson Johnson hits the first basket of the second half for the Hawks as he was left alone. And Johnson now with 15 points as he had 13 at halftime. 38-30. And now Broderick, top of the key for three. It's no good. And a rebound, Rio Aguirre. We'll get our first half statistics in with Jimmy Cataldo. We want to thank Kristen Meyer, the Dowling girls head coach, along with Ellie Olson visiting with us at halftime, talking about the Dowling girls' win tonight, 56-27 over Ankeny. Now, the Hawks in the lane, their shot no good, rebound Dowling. And Maroons starting, I believe, there's who they started the game with. Here's Coppola, a shot in the lane, it's no good. And it's kept alive by Broderick, and they get it underneath the net, and his layup is good. Good hustle by Joe Broderick, and there might be a divot on the baseline here, Jimmy.
Just, I mean, a big play by Joe Broderick. The ball's flailing out of bounds. He gives up his body and tips it back in to Riddick Metten, who finishes the two-point shot.
Metten with 16 points to lead all scorers tonight. And now ball deflected in the backcourt after a missed Ankeny shot. Now the Hawks will dribble it back in the front court. Carson Johnson for three, top of the key. It's no good. And Joey Coppola with the rebound. It's Joey and Maddox Coppola, the two guards, along with Riddick Metten, Joe Broderick, and Ryan Kleppe. And now Metten for three, and it's good from the top of the key. He is on fire. He's got 19 points, and that is his third three of the night.
I was going to say, I think that's his third three. You know, big timely shots by Riddick. He's certainly feeling it, 19 points. If he can stay hot, Maroons are certainly getting to the basket.
All right, here's Ankeny. Rio Aguirre fakes the three, gets it underneath, and now they dump it inside to Cade Peterson, and he draws the foul, and that'll give us an opportunity to get our first half statistics in with Ankeny's lead now 38-35 over Dowling, and the foul is on Riddick Metten. Jimmy?
Ankeny goes 14 of 25 from the field for 56%, 15 rebounds, 5 turnovers. For the Maroons through two quarters, 13 of 29 from the field, which includes 3 of 13 from 3, 13 rebounds and 3 turnovers.
That foul was on Ryan Kleppe. Second free throw is no good. So Peterson goes 1 for 2. He has 3 points tonight. 39-35. Ankeny by 4. Runs with the basketball. Here is Broderick. Jump stop in the lane, kicks it out to Kleppe for three. It's off the back iron, no good. Metten with an offensive rebound. Goes baseline, kicks it out to Broderick. And Joe will put his head down, gets underneath, jump stops, and he drew the foul before the shot on Ankeny, and it'll be on Cade Peterson.
Yeah, Joe Broderick hasn't scored yet in the game, and he's a double-digit scorer, and he's just not really getting to the basket as well as he has in past games, settled for a few three-point shots, but this time, the last two possessions, he's been getting to the basket. Maybe that's a point of emphasis here now.
Now a backdoor cut and a layup. Good reverse layup as a pass went inside to Maddox Coppola for his fourth point. Great inbounds play that time for the Maroons. They cut it to two. It's 39-37. Ankeny by two with 4:40 left to go, third quarter. Mark Amadale, Jimmy Cataldo here at the Ankeny Gym as we are courtside with our broadcast. Just beyond the Ankeny or the Dowling bench. Now a corner three. It's no good by Rio Aguirre. Rebound Dowling. Kings with their starting five in there. And now Joey Coppola for three, trying to give Dowling the lead. It's no good. Carson Johnson with the rebound for Ankeny. Outlet pass to Leo Aguirre. Leaves it for his brother, Rio Aguirre. Little two-man game between them. Now here's Cash Schoolin down the lane, and he loses it out of bounds. And they're going to – officials will get together. Dowling thinks it went off of the leg of an Ankeny player. And it'll be Dowling basketball.
One of the hard spots on the court that we can't see being in the corner here. So you're really looking for the officials and and how they're signaling their calls. But
I'm just ready for you to ask Coach Einerson to you please sit down, because I got a good view. I'm right on the baseline. You, on the other hand, you're a little bit deeper on the other side of the table. That's all right. We're seated right on the baseline and sideline right here in the northwest corner here at Ankeny. Here's Coppola with it. Is Dowling a chance to tie or take the lead? Maroons have led once in this game by two back in the first quarter. A long three by Metten is no good. Offensive rebound. Kleppy put back up and in right in front of us. How about that?
Big play by Kleppy right around the rim, getting the offensive rebound and sticking back in. The Maroons have done a great job when they hit those offensive rebounds and getting their second shot scores.
We'll take a one-minute break with 3:32 to go here in the third quarter. We're tied at 39. Dowling and Ankeny here on Iowa Catholic Radio.
Have you heard that the church once prohibited Bible reading, or that the scriptures were kept in Latin so the people couldn't understand it? Some myths die hard, I guess. Yes, the church has taken a cautious approach to protect God's word from those who would mistranslate it or distort its meaning, especially when you consider that the majority of the world's population was and remains illiterate and uneducated. That being said, Catholic popes and bishops in every century have encouraged Catholics to learn and meditate upon God's written word. The Bible was in Latin, so it wasn't a dead language, but the universal educational language of the Western world. Anyone who was going to read the Bible would have been able to read it in Latin. And at a time when dialects changed within very short distances, it was important to have a standard language for the church. Still, the Catholic Church did allow translations of the Bible into the local languages. In fact, when Luther did his famous Bible translation into German, over 25 had already been done. The Catholic Society of the Middle Ages was one deeply steeped in the scriptures, as Henry Graham's great book, Where We Got the Bible, explains. Consider this, their greatest works of architecture were neither skyscrapers nor sports stadiums, but cathedrals built to the glory of God. This is Greg Ewell for Faith Check.
And we're back here at the Ankeny Gym. Mark Amadale alongside Jimmy Cataldo. Ankeny takes a timeout, tied at 39. Both teams with four timeouts remaining. And the Maroons have come out like gangbusters here, Jimmy, here in this third quarter with 3:20 remaining. Now the Hawks with 20 on the shot clock. Leo Aguirre bounces in. His shot up and no good. Drew the foul. And he'll go back to the free throw line, will Leo.
The Maroons have been defending well, at least in this early second half, and really forcing Ankeny into some tough shots and getting rebounds. The Maroons are sitting six rebounds here in the second or third quarter alone.
Maddox Coppola picks up the foul. That's his first. Gary's first free throw is good. So the Hawks now are 6 of 9 at the line, make it 7 of 10. 41-39, Ankeny by two. 3:10 to go here in the third quarter. Dowling, no changes in their lineup. Maddox and Joey Coppola, the guards. Riddick Metten, Brian Kleppy, the forwards. And Joe Broderick at center, the Dowling five. Here's Kleppy, top of the key right wing. Hands it off to Metten. Riddick down the lane and lose the ball out of bounds. And they're going to give it to Dowling. Riddick expecting contact, didn't really get any, and loses it out of bounds. They say it went off of Ankeny.
He's certainly feeling it tonight. He's taking the ball to the basket with a ton of confidence. And the way the ball went off his hand there, you would think that there was a little bit of body.
On the lane, Metten shot up no good, and he loses it out of bounds. Riddick had a good look at the basket, but he altered his shot. I don't know if he needed to do that, as we had a great look at it here. And it'll be turnover to Ankeny with 2:45 to go in the third.
His speed to the basket is causing Ankeny some issues. And so some more isolation plays for Riddick could certainly help out the Maroons and continue to pound away at this game.
Carson Johnson for three, no good. It hits the guy wire as it bounces off the rim. over the backboard. It'll be Dowling basketball. And not a whole lot of substitutions right now, Jimmy, for either team.
Maroons feel pretty confident with their lineup and getting offensive play by.
I'm going to get Metten for the travel. So the other way we go, turnover against Dowling.
You know, the Maroons are doing well handling the ball. I mean, that's their fifth turnover for the game. Normally, you know, we're talking about turnover issues for the Maroons, but right now they're handling the ball pretty well, limiting their turnovers.
And Ankeny with the ball. They work it inside, and it's knocked out of bounds. Riddick Metten, the leading scorer for Dowling. 19 points tonight. He had 14 at halftime. Maddox Capola with 4 points. Ryan Kleppe with 11. Joe Broderick is yet to score. Joey Capola with just 2 points tonight. And the Maroons have not got inside as they. Ankeny puts up a shot. It's no good. Might have been partially blocked. A rebound out to Dowling. And now Kleppe underneath. His shot up and no good. He drew the foul, and that'll be on Aguirre. That'll be Leal's second.
Sending the Maroons to the line for the first time tonight.
Yeah, first free throws. How many threes attempted?
18 three-point shots attempted by the Maroons.
Okay. And there are none made here in the third quarter, so you're. Oh, free throw no good by Kleppe. Maroons 0 for 1 at the line. Second one on its way. Carson Johnson, leading scorer for Ankeny with 15 points. He had 13 at halftime. Second free throw. No good. Rolls off the rim. Rebounded by Schoolin. Tough break for the Maroons there. Had a chance to get it tied, and now Ankeny with the 2-point lead and the basketball with 1:45 to go. Now here's a steal on the baseline by Kleppe. Anticipated that. Outlet pass to Broderick. Good defense by Ankeny. They get back with 1.5 to play, and Dowling down 2 here in the final stages of the third quarter. Now Metten underneath, his shot no good. Broderick with the rebound, put back, partially blocked, and rebounded by Ankeny and Cash Schoolin. Boy, they're battling on the boards.
Hey, sir, I think Schoolin's doing a tremendous job defending Joe Broderick, really not allowing him to get the ball down low and taking away any.
Now here's a steal by Dowling and a layup up and no good by Joey Capola. Breakaway. Maroons can't get it tied. Rebound out to Ankeny with 55 seconds remaining. Here's Carson Johnson underneath. He has the ball stripped away. Here's Kleppe with it. Over to Broderick. His shot up and no good, and Joe hits the floor. Foul on Ankeny, and it'll be on Rio Aguirre.
You know, that steal by Joey Capola, he takes the ball across the rim for his layup and really could have just taken it right at the play side rim and made that shot much easier, but he tried to avoid any contact by the defender and went across the rim.
So Rio Aguirre with his third foul. First free throw of the night for Joe Broderick is good. Joe with his first point of the evening. Tonight's game on Iowa Catholic Radio brought to you in part by the Catholic Tuition Organization, Skeffington's. Our thanks also to Klein Electric for their support of our broadcast here on Iowa Catholic Radio. Busy week as we'll be back at it on Thursday night. Dowling at Southeast Polk, or Dowling at Valley, and then Friday night at Southeast Polk. So three road games this week. And then next Monday, as Dante Cataldo checks into the Dowling lineup, he'll replace Maddox Capola. Also in there is Nick Frericks. And free throws good by the Maroons. And that was Broderick making them both. And we've got a timeout on the floor. We'll keep it here. And it's time now for our Dowling Catholic High School Activity Spotlight. As we're tied at 41 here in the final 49 seconds of the third quarter here at the Ankeny Gym. Congratulations to January's recipient. That's Zeb Fitzgerald, Dowling Catholic Class of 2024, for being a recognized witness to the very best of faith, academics, and student activities. And you can hear Zeb's interview with John Leonetti on the Catholic Morning Show by visiting Iowa Catholic Radio's podcast page at iowacatholicradio.com. That interview was done on Tuesday, January 16th. Zeb belongs to St. Anthony's Parish. His parents are Joe and Katie. Brother Keegan, who's a junior, and his sister Eden, who's a seventh grader, belonging to our home parish, St. Anthony's Parish on Des Moines' south side. Our thanks to the sponsor of Dowling Catholic High School Activity Spotlight. Brightside Aesthetics by Ducharme Dermatology and Clive, offering a wide range of aesthetic and wellness services and providing customized care to have you looking your best. Learn more at brightsideiowa.com. And congratulations to Zeb Fitzgerald. He's a wrestler in the winter. And
a great kid, great family. Know the Fitzgeralds well. And congratulations to Zeb, and well-earned recognition.
All right, we're back in action with 40 seconds to play. Tied at 41, Ankeny with the ball. They get it to Leo Aguirre, going against Aliere. His shot up and falls through right over Aliere, a guy who's in the Dowling lineup, all 6'8" of him. And Leo Aguirre with his sixth point. Check that, seventh point. 43-41, Ankeny in this boys' CIML conference in Class 4A. Ankeny Hawks ranked ninth in 4A. Runes try to lob it inside, stolen away by Carson Johnson. All the way down, his shot no good. Ball and bodies all over the floor, and the Maroons try to save it out of bounds. They step on the baseline as Johnson hits the deck. And it'll be Ankeny basketball with 5.7 seconds remaining. Maddox Coppola will check into the Dowling lineup, replacing Riddick Metten.
Give Riddick a little bit of extra time to rest for a fourth quarter run. And
Hawks inbound the ball. Now they get it to Leo Aguirre, and it's tipped away, and now Leo retrieves it. Tries to get it underneath to Peterson. He threw it away. It'll be Dowling basketball with 9/10 of a second remaining.
I think tipped out of bounds by Dowling on that.
So Ankeny will have it in the corner. Throwing it in will be Luke Anderson. Why not have the quarterback throw it in? 9/10 of a second remaining. They get it to Carson Johnson. His shot at the horn is no good. And we've come to the end of the third quarter with the score. Ankeny 43, Dowling 41. Alongside Jimmy Cataldo, Mark Hemmedale, earlier tonight, the Dowling girls a winner, 56-27 over Ankeny. We'll return to the fourth quarter here at the Dowling at the Ankeny Gym on Iowa Catholic Radio.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio is provided by Boson the Florist. Valentine's Day, Mother's Day, weddings, whatever the message, say more with Boson. Boson.com, 515-244-ROSE. Boson makes the moment mean more.
Brightside Aesthetics by Ducharme Dermatology provides advanced and medical aesthetics, body contouring, wellness, and spa services. Learn more at brightsideiowa.com. Thank you, Brightside Aesthetics, for your support of Iowa Catholic Radio.
Fast Signs is a custom sign and visual solutions company with an extensive selection of digital signage, interior and exterior signs, banners, and vehicle wraps. Learn more at fastsigns.com. Thank you, Fast Signs in Clive, for your support of Iowa Catholic Radio.
Support for programming comes from Klein Electric, a local family-oriented electrical contractor, a 100% employee-owned company with branches across the Midwest to provide comprehensive electrical services. Klein Electric is able to help with any residential and commercial project. Learn more at kleinelectric.com.
And we're back here for the fourth quarter at the Ankeny Gym, Tuesday night, Central Iowa Metro League basketball here on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network. Mark Amadale alongside Jimmy Cataldo. Other games going on tonight. Valley's at Johnson, Ankeny Centennial at Waukee, Southeast Polk at Urbandale, and the boys' contest, Grandview Christian at Waukee Northwest. Waukee Northwest girls have the night off in the CIML. Dowling had the ball first, and Jimmy, they didn't come away. Again, came away with the empty possession.
Joey Coppola had a great look, dribble drive to the right side of the rim, and just comes up short on his layup, but had a really good look to convert and just didn't get it in.
All right, Ankeny with the ball. They work it inside, and they get it to their big center. That's Cade Peterson with the basket. For Cade, that's just his second field goal of the night. He's got 5 points. 45-41, the Ankeny lead is now 4. Dowling with the ball. Here's Maddox Coppola trying to go around Carson Johnson. Haven't seen any zone tonight except for Dowling's press. Back in the first half. We haven't seen that in the second half. Now Metten in the lane, and he stumbles and falls. Picked up by Ankeny, and here's Luke Anderson with it. Underneath the schooling, and he draws the foul. And it'll be out of bounds to Ankeny. as the Maroons now will bring into their lineup number 15, Lucas Paoli, for the second time tonight.
Taking Riddick out, I think just cool him down a little bit. You know, Riddick, sometimes when things go sideways for him, motions kind of get the best of him. But a good substitution just to relax him, because they're going to need him here for this fourth quarter run.
Fouls on Maddox Coppola, his second. I got some moisture on the court. Down here where we're at on the opposite end, where the ball is at. Tonight's game on Iowa Catholic Radio brought to you in part by Bozen the Florist, Ashworth Vision Clinic, and Construction Professionals. Up next for Dowling, they have two games remaining this week. We'll be with them at Valley on Thursday and at Southeast Polk on Friday. For Ankeny, they're off this week. They'll take on Waukee Northwest here next Tuesday night. And now a pull-up jumper by Carson Johnson. Rolls off the rim, no good. Rebound Dowling. Here's Paoli with it. Young man getting some playing time tonight. Lucas Paoli, a 6-foot junior. Coming off a ball screen. Looking inside. Can't get it to Broderick. Now does. 20 on the shot clock. Now the pass goes through Ryan Kleppe into the hands of Leo Aguirre. Turnover against Dowling.
Just bad turnovers early in the fourth quarter. Maroons were within two, and they had a turnover early, and within four, I'd have another turnover. These possessions are so important that the margin of error is so tight. You can limit the turnover, especially in the fourth quarter.
Coppola picks up. This is Maddox Coppola with his third foul. As Ankeny had the ball tipped away, but they say Coppola got too much to the body. Now they work it inside to Peterson. His layup is good. Cade Peterson on the inbounds play with his seventh point. 47-41. The Ankeny lead is six. There's Riddick Metten. Down the lane he goes. His shot off the glass, partially blocked. Rebound Broderick. Joe double team and a reach-in foul on Peterson of Ankeny. So Cade will pick up his first foul. With 6 minutes to play here in the fourth quarter, Dowling trailing by six. Maroons had the game tied in the latter stages of the third quarter. Underneath to Kleppe. His shot no good. Defended by Luke Anderson, and Anderson comes away with the rebound. Underneath Carson Johnson, his shot no good. Rebound. Cade Peterson, and he puts it through. Peterson was battling underneath with Kleppe, and the foul on Coppola they're going to call it on, and that'll be Joey's third.
The Maroons have a great look on the inbounds pass, and Ryan Kleppe just gets a little bit deep in underneath the basket. Doesn't have a great angle, but still open layup, misses it. And the Maroons come down and don't get a defensive rebound.
Now the first free throw is no good, and we've got a timeout on the floor. With 6:02 to go here in the fourth quarter, it's 49-41. And let's see, nobody's sitting down, so this will be a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it here. Thanks to Fast Signs. Our thanks to Blessman International and Skeffington's Formal Wear. 49-41, Ankeny by 8. Girls game tonight, won by Dowling, 56-27. And Dowling now, are they going to do a redo on that free throw? Was there a lane violation or not?
I believe Coach Ironson was trying to call a timeout before the first free throw. They let it go, gave the timeout after the first free throw. The first free throw does count, which was a miss.
Right. Okay. That's what I have.
But the Maroons, you know, right. 6 minutes to go in the game, so just 2 minutes off the clock. And, you know, they came into this quarter just down two, sitting at down eight, just under 2 minutes gone on the fourth quarter. Just have just not taken advantage of some good looks that they're getting close to the rim, which Einerson talked about. They weren't converting against Johnston, and they were certainly not getting it done here in the fourth quarter.
And the second free throw by Peterson, no good. So he stays on 9 points. Going 0 for 2 there. Rebound Dowling. So here's Broderick with it after the pass from Joey Coppola. Now to Maddox Coppola for three. It's no good. Fight for the rebound. Slapped around. Joey Coppola feeds Kleppe inside, and the layup is good. Good hustle by Joey Coppola keeping that ball alive.
Tacked the basket on the shot and got rewarded with the offensive rebound. And great cut by Kleppe to the hoop.
Kleppe with 13 points. He joins Riddick Metten with double figures, who has 19. And now inside, Aguirre loses it. Stolen away by Dowling. Here's Joey Coppola underneath the Broderick. 49-43. And Broderick's left-handed hook shot, no good. Rebound, Kleppe. Out of Metten with 5:10 to go. We got a whistle and a foul on Ankeny. And they're going to whistle it on Luke Anderson. That'll be his first.
You look at it, Joey Coppola. You know, Joey's one of your leading scorers.
So 49-43, and head coach Justin Anderson just picked up a warning from one of the referees. So it's not a technical foul, but it is a warning. 49-43, Ankeny, 5:10 to go, and Dowling will have the ball on the baseline. Coppola gets it to Broderick. Not a Kleppe. Kleppe underneath, the shot up, and no good, drew the foul. And that'll be on Luke Anderson, his second, and Ryan back to the free throw line for Dowling.
The Maroons have just been either strong at the hoop or short at the hoop, but they're just not getting that open layup to go, and Ryan does a great job getting to the hoop. Drew the contact and just couldn't get the ball to get into the basket, and those and-ones are big in this part of the game, but still credit Ryan Kleppe for attacking the basket, sitting at 14 points, just having a really good game tonight. See if the Maroons can cut the lead down to four here.
Kleppe 1-for-3 at the line tonight. Second free throw, in and out, no good. Rebound, Ankeny. Carson Johnson, Cade Peterson, Leo Aguirre. His brother Rio Aguirre in the lineup for the Hawks and Cash Schoolin. So the Hawks to their starting five. Corner three up and good by Rio Aguirre. That is a backbreaker. And Rio with 15 points. Ooh. Now Dowling comes back. Three-pointer by Metten is up and good. He's got 22. 52-47, Ankeny by five. Not going to be near the 70 points each team scored back in December. Again, a three-pointer up and no good by Rio Aguirre. Rebound on the floor, and Dowling comes away with it. Maddox Coppola. Kleppe got the rebound and finally got it to Maddox. There's Metten for three. It's short. And the rebound, Ankeny and Rio Aguirre. One and done is Dowling there. Maroons trail by five with under 4 minutes to play in the fourth. Here's Leo Aguirre with it. To Rio Aguirre, now to Carson Johnson. Carson well defended by Riddick Metten. 10 on the shot clock. Carson Johnson, pull up jumper, no good. Rebound slap around, Broderick has it for Dowling. Maroons trying to cut into that 5-point lead. This will be the third possession since. Here's Kleppe for three, top of the key, good. Kleppe with 17 points. He and Metten, who has 22, are leading the way tonight. And a timeout, Ankeny. With 3:12 to go here in the fourth quarter, it's Ankeny 52 and Dowling 50. And this will be a full timeout. We'll take it with them. With 3:12 to go, fourth quarter, Ankeny 52, Dowling 50. From the Ankeny gym, Mark Emmerdale and Jimmy Cataldo will return after these messages on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network.
This is a Young Catholic Minute.
How come women can't be priests? I thought Vatican II got rid of sexism.
How come men can't have babies? I thought God created us equal.
He did. But equal in dignity doesn't mean exactly the same. If we think that the only reason that men can't have babies is because they don't have a uterus, or that the only reason women can't be spiritual fathers in the priesthood is because of some antiquated rules, we've fallen into our society's favorite error, separating the physical and spiritual world. The role of a father, of lover to loved, existed in God before he ever created humans. And when he did, he made men for fatherhood and women for motherhood. So why can't men give birth?
They're not created for it, physically or spiritually. Why can't women be priests? They're not created for it, physically or spiritually. And if we deny that, we deny the truth of the spiritual world. And if we do that, we have to deny God. And that's just no good. For more, go to youngcatholicminute.com.
And we're back here at the Ankeny Gym. Mark Amadale alongside Jimmy Cataldo. 3:10 left to play here in the fourth quarter. Ankeny's lead now down to 2, 52-50. Now Leo Aguirre has the ball, tried a little pass from block to block to Peterson, and it's tipped away by Dowling. The Maroons are just closer and closer here, Jimmy, as they've overcome, what, a couple deficits, an 11-point deficit. They were down 5 here in the last few minutes. Now the Hawks underneath, Schoolen with the basket as he gets loose in the lane, and that is Cash Schoolen's first point since the first half. He's got 9. 54-50, Ankeny by 4. Now underneath, and that's Riddick Met staying hot, shoots and scores. He's got 24.
Tough angle with Aguirre in his face, but converts from the side and continues to stay, keep the Maroons within 2.
2:30 remaining in the fourth quarter. Both teams, let's see, timeouts. Ankeny has 3, Dowling has 2. Ankeny by 2, here's Aguirre. Backs in Kleppe on the right block. A pump fake, a shot no good, gets his own rebound, does Aguirre, and a put back up and in with the left hand. Leo Aguirre. He's got 8 points. Make that 10 points. And it's 56-52, Ankeny by 4. Here's Metten with it, and they're going to get him for traveling. Oh, jump ball they're going to call. Never mind.
Possession goes to Ankeny.
Ankeny don't have the ball with a minute 58 to play in the possession arrow.
Yeah, with the 35-second shot clock, I mean, you can continue to stay in your defense. You're not forced to really foul. Maroons are sitting. Both teams are at 3 fouls, so either foul does not send anybody to the line. So you can stay into your defense. You got the lead to 4.
Now foul on Kleppe as he tried to overplay the passing lane. That'll be his 2nd.
Now any foul by the Maroons puts Ankeny on the line shooting 2.
That's a 14 foul on Dowling, 3 on Ankeny. Yeah, it's a little different game, Jimmy, when you eliminate the one-on-ones, which the High School Federation has done this year for high school basketball.
It induces defense, and that's what you want to. You want teams to be good at defense and not have to foul to hope to have kids miss free throws.
All right, Ankeny now winds the shot clock down to 10. Here's Carson Johnson, guarded by Maddox Capole. Long 3, good. Oh, that's a backbreaker there. Carson Johnson, his first 3 of the night, and he's got 18 points.
What a shot. Hand in his face.
59-52, and a Capola, or rather Kleppe, comes back, and a 3-pointer good. He's got 20. And a timeout called by Dowling, and they're going to go with the minute timeout. We will, too, with 59 seconds remaining here in the fourth quarter, 59-55. Ankeny by 4 over Dowling. We'll return after these messages on Iowa Catholic Radio.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio comes from Westgate Dental, offering cosmetic, family, implant, and general dentistry. Located at 1073rd Street, Suite 1 in West Des Moines, just behind Dowling Catholic High School. Learn more at westgatedentalia.com.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio is provided by Skeffington's Formal Wear, in business since 1951 with locations in Des Moines, West Des Moines, Coralville, and Ankeny. Skeffington's Formal Wear, fitting you for life celebrations. Online at skeffingtons.com.
Support for programming funded by Blessman International. We bring the good news of the gospel to South African children and their families through faith formation and locally sustainable programs. As the Fellowship of Christian Athletes location for all South Africa, our Sports for Christ complex provides student access to friendly competition where discipline and dedication are developed. Learn how you can support programs like Sports for Christ or experience the hands-on engagement of a mission trip at blessmaninternational.org.
KWKY Des Moines, K233BT Des Moines, KIHS Adel.
Hey, we're back here at the Ankeny Gym. I want to thank everybody here at Ankeny High School for getting us set up with our broadcast tonight as we're courtside here on the baseline. 59-55, Ankeny by four over Dowling, under a minute to play. Ankeny breaking the Dowling press. Here's Luke Anderson in the front court. Gets it over to Carson Johnson. And now they pass underneath to Rio Aguirre. It's poked out of bounds, and they say it went off of Dowling. Metten was involved with that, maybe Broderick, and a timeout of Ankeny. We'll keep it here. 48 seconds remaining.
One of the areas we can't,
see.
It seems like, you know, the crowd didn't agree with the call. But
Here's your guy up there, Mr. Assistant Coach of the Year, Mr. Andy Pollock.
I got this kick in
camera.
My neck, and, you know, been looking to my right the whole time tonight.
Tonight's game on Iowa Catholic Radio, we appreciate our supporters and business underwriters. They include Klein Electric, Construction Professionals, and Ashworth Vision Clinic. We appreciate them. Our next broadcast will be Thursday night. We'll be at the Valley Fieldhouse, the Bill Coldiron Fieldhouse. 6 o'clock will be on the air. Girls game at 6:15. Boys game to follow at 7:45. Dowling at Valley. This is the makeup game, which has been rescheduled due to the week we had two winter storms. So we'll get one out of the way there. Dowling girls will make up their snow out against Ankeny Centennial next Monday up at Centennial. Dowling boys will play that night against Hoover. Now whistling a foul on Kleppy as he tried to steal the ball away from Rio Aguirre. And Ryan will commit his third foul. 44 seconds remaining. That'll be the, 15th foul on Dowling. So two shots for the Hawks. As Rio Aguirre, 66% free throw shooter, hits the first. He's got 14 points. Second one on the way. Good. 15 points for Rio Aguirre. 61-55. Ankeny by six. Dowling now. Here's Coppola for three. No good. Offensive rebound put back by Riddick Metten. He's got 26. Now whistling a backcourt foul on Dowling with 31 seconds remaining. Maroons trail by four.
Maroons are forced to foul here. You know, it's a two-possession game.
Kleppy picks up the foul. That's his fourth.
Carson and Johnson, 89% free throw shooter on the year.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. You foul that guy, and he's perfect on the night. Two for two is Johnson. First one up, good. Thanks to the Ankeny folks, Athletic Director Mike Baker, who took over January 1st. Second free throw by Johnson, in and out, no good. Rebound Dowling. Tom Day, Lisa Meeker, and all the staff here, appreciate them helping us out. Here's a long three by Broderick, no good. Rebound Carson Johnson, and that might do it. 20 seconds remaining, foul in the backcourt. 62-57 Ankeny.
Just, you know, the Maroons just don't have much answer. If it's going to a three-point shooting contest, they're just so much better attacking the basket and then looking for the kick out. But right now, they're just, you know, trying to set a ball screen. Just is not a very successful offense for the Maroons. But again, hand it to Ankeny. Ankeny, you know, Dowling got close at times, cut it to two at times and more than once. And then Ankeny just continued to play their game and made shots and got to the free throw line. It's their 19th free throw on the night.
Carson Johnson makes them both. He's got 21 points. Dowling the other way. And now Coppola's shot is blocked by Schoolin. Rebound to Aguirre, and that's Rio Aguirre. And a foul in the backcourt by Maddox Coppola. That'll be his fourth with 12 seconds remaining, and the Hawks are going to pull this one out. Ankeny ranked ninth this week on the high school rankings in Class 4A. We're going to prove their record to 10-4. Dowling's going to fall below 500 as the free throw is good by Aguirre, who has 16 points. Second free throw also good. 17 points for Rio Aguirre. 66-57. Corner three up and good by Kleppy. And he's got 23 points, and that'll do it. Final score, Ankeny 66, Dowling Catholic 60 here at the Ankeny Gym. As the Maroons hung around but just couldn't overtake the Hawks, they got it tied right before the fourth quarter. But, you know, as Coach mentioned, you got to attempt more free throws than you attempt threes, and that did not happen for Dowling tonight. That was shot in the water, and our thanks goes to Ankeny on that, because you got to credit the Hawks with their game plan.
Well, the Maroons had the game right where they wanted it going into the fourth quarter. They started the fourth quarter down two, I believe, and had some good looks, just could not get, you know, converting at the rim. And that's something Coach Einerson talked about against Johnston. They were 1 of 15 around the rim finishing against Johnston. And for the most part, in three quarters, the Maroons were attacking the basket, were getting their buckets at and around the paint. Just in the fourth quarter, they just went ice cold around the rim. And then, you know, credit goes to Ankeny. They got to the free throw line multiple times there in the fourth quarter, converting their shots, and the Maroons were left to be a three-point shooting team, which just has not been statistically what they've been great at. But defensively, Cam Schoolin, he's a guy that came out that looked – he shut Joey Coppola down when he was guarding Joey. Joe Broderick, he went on Joe Broderick and caused a lot of issues with Joe Broderick, who finished with just 2 points tonight. But offensively, Riddick Metnant and Ryan Kleppy were the straw that stirred the drink tonight for the Maroons. Played extremely well. Metnant's 26 points and Kleppy with 23, and just offensively were the two guys that really stood out for the Maroons.
Well, the Maroons outscored Ankeny 21-15 in the second quarter. They cut it to five at halftime, 35-30, and Dowling outscored Ankeny in the third quarter, 11-8, but it was in that fourth quarter the Hawks outscored Dowling to close it out 23-19 as Ankeny wins at 66-60. The Hawks go to 10-4 on the season. Dowling falls to 6-7 in boys' play, where the Dowling girls, third-ranked Dowling girls tonight, a winner over seventh-ranked Ankeny, 56-27. So it's a doubleheader split here at the Ankeny Gym. Mark Amadale alongside Jimmy Cataldo. We'll take a two-minute break, come back with our post-game show. Brady Grimm back at the Iowa Catholic Radio Studios. Appreciate him tonight. And we'll be back with our post-game show following Ankeny's win tonight over Dowling 66-60 here on Iowa Catholic Radio.
Our Lord warns us repeatedly about the dangers of riches. Scripture tells the story of the rich young man that was unable to respond to Jesus' invitation to follow him due to his many possessions. And then there is Jesus' statement that it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God, to which his disciples reply, "Who then can be saved?" As people living amid great material prosperity, we must be especially vigilant not to be subtly seduced by greed or materialism with their false promises of contentment with each shiny new purchase. To combat these temptations, we are called to strive for gospel poverty and simplicity, not fill our lives with clutter and excess possessions. Malachi 3 reminds us not to skimp when it comes to our tithing, but to offer God our first fruits, not our leftovers. Tobit shows us that almsgiving, properly done, is not merely a good deed, but a sacrificial offering to the Lord. And St. Paul instructs us that when we give, it must be done with a generous and cheerful heart, not grudgingly. Let us aim to acquire true riches, where moth and rust cannot consume, thieves cannot steal, and the latest upgrade is never needed. This is Greg Ewell for Faith Check.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio comes from the Catholic Tuition Organization. Reduce or eliminate your Iowa income tax and instead give to the Catholic Tuition Organization and receive 75% Iowa tax credits. These tax credits are going fast, so reserve yours today and learn more about the Catholic Tuition Organization at ctoiowa.org. ctoiowa.org. The bottom line, it's for the kids and their futures.
Catholic Tuition Organization, a great investment in our kids.
Support for programming is provided by Construction Professionals, serving customers through a proven process, creating unique design, functionality, and artistic beauty. Construction Professionals is a Catholic family business built on a strong foundation. CPCustomHomes.com.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio is provided by Ashworth Vision Clinic. Complete eye exams, contact lenses, glasses, glaucoma testing, and urgent eye issues. 515-440-4610. AshworthVision.com.
Welcome back to the postgame show here on Iowa Catholic Radio alongside Jimmy Cataldo, Mark Amadill. The first of three games this week as the Maroons make up a game Thursday night at Valley. We'll be there at 6 o'clock with our pregame show. And Friday night out at Southeast Polk. So all road games. And then, as I mentioned to our listeners, next Monday, Jimmy, Dowling boys host Hoover at the Dowling Gym at 6:15. And the Dowling girls will make up their game with Centennial that night up at Ankeny Centennial High School at 6:15. So I figured we'd have two different sets of equipment. You might go over and call the boys.
You don't trust me? I was going to say, you don't trust me?
Call the boys game and instead.
Give it to Swaim and I.
Oh,
I mean, goodness. Hand this off and see what we can do.
So Babinette and I can stay up here.
Perfect.
I'll give you the backup unit, and you can go to Dowling and have Denny O'Grady do color for you.
And we're going
to
go out there and tout ratings and see who can.
Well, that's our dilemma on Monday. So what we're going to do is Mr. Babinette and I will be up here doing the top five game between Centennial and Dowling girls Monday night. And you'll be at the Dowling gym watching your son. And I'll be exchanging text messages with the PA announcer at Dowling, Denny O'Grady, and we'll get you. So you'll have our score and we'll have yours. How's that?
That's perfect.
Okay.
You know,
we'll do that now.
Seeing that you can multitask may put you in for a race.
Well, you really got on me. I was off two free throws, and I found it. It was Leo Aguirre. I forgot to put his two misses down, and that was causing all that confusion. Found it. You
got to have some quality control at this table.
Where?
Right here. I mean, we got to find you, and we got to make sure we correct your mistakes. Because
well, there's plenty. There can be. All right. Well, you got all the stats done. You got the calculator work tonight?
There's a lot of shots that went up tonight.
Yeah, I was gonna say, you talked about that. It's like, all right, here you go, folks. The stats from Ankeny, yes. Dowling. Maroons on the short end tonight. Ankeny 66, Dowling 60 in boys action. And Jimmy Cataldo, you got the unofficial stats,
let's
right?
Let's start with the victorious Ankeny Hawks. Ankeny goes 23 of 47 from the field, 48%. The 27 total rebounds and 10 turnovers. They went 14 of 21 from the free throw line. That was just an incredible stat compared to the Maroons, just going 3 of 6. But for the Maroons in the fourth quarter, or through four quarters, 24 of 59 for 40% from the field, 8 of 26 from threes, 31 rebounds and 8 turnovers. And just the tail of the tape, I thought the Maroons fought. The game got away from them a little bit in the first quarter. They fought back. Third quarter, they went toe-to-toe with Ankeny into the fourth quarter, just down two, and just couldn't convert around the rim, which was extremely costly for the Maroons, and settled for some three-point shots that just didn't hit in the second half, and just not getting to the free throw line. Coach Einarsson talked about getting to the free throw line more than you shoot threes. Well, they shot 26 threes on the night and just 6 free throws, so certainly tell the tape when you look at what kind of happened to the Maroons there.
That's an interesting formula, and there was a lot of shots. You're exactly right. Let's take a look at scoring tonight. First of all, for the visitors from Dowling Catholic, the Maroons had two players in double figures, both over 20 points, led by senior Reddick Metten. Reddick with 26 points tonight. He was followed by senior Ryan Kleppe with 23 points. And then rounding out scoring, big drop down, Maddox Coppola with 4 points. 3 points for Lucas Paoli, who came in off the bench. 2 points for Joe Broderick and 2 points for Joey Coppola. Cole Souther, Dante Cataldo, Nick Furries played, and so did Ali Aragao for the Maroons and did not score. Dowling, as you mentioned, 6 free throw attempts, 3 made. So Maroons were 3 of 6 at the line tonight. For Ankeny, they were led by Carson Johnson. He's headed to Minnesota Moorhead next year, Division II school in Minnesota. Johnson with 21 points led the Hawks in scoring. He was followed by Rio Aguirre, the 6'1 sophomore, with 17 points. His brother, older brother, Leo Aguirre, a 6'3 senior, with 10 points. 9 points for Cade Peterson for the Hawks, and 9 points for Case Shulin. Luke Anderson came in, did not score for Ankeny, and that was their only reserve that we had noted on there. The Hawks went 14 of 21 at the free throw line. So even then, in that comparison, 21 free throw attempts by Ankeny and 6 by Dowling Catholic.
And that's the tail of the tape, as we said. I thought you look at two guys that are big contributors offensively for the Maroons, Joey Coppola and Joe Broderick, held to 2 points apiece. And watching them play on their offensive side, I would give a lot of credit to Cash Schoolin. I thought Cash Schoolin, who interchanged defensively against those two, did a great job limiting their input to the Dowling offense, and that fell on the shoulders of Metten and Kleppe, and I would imagine that's a career high for Kleppe with 23 and Riddick Metten for that matter, and it just wasn't enough for the Maroons as they fell short, and most of it came in that fourth quarter.
Well, it certainly did, Jimmy, as we're joined now by Justin Einertsen, the Dowling boys basketball coach, following Ankeny's win tonight here at the Ankeny Gym, 66-60. And, Coach, we were just talking about the formula you talked about at halftime of the girls' contest, made threes versus free throws attempted. And
We weren't going to get those tonight with this group.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I mean, Rudy's got it covered full of moral victories this season, so we can continue along that route, but, you know, more opportunities ahead, so... We are more battle-tested than your average team. We can take the best in the state down to two possessions just about any night. It's just about getting two possessions better, three possessions better.
Well, when you look at the rankings out here, the Waukee Valley, Ankeny, Centennial, and Ankeny all in the top 10 in Class 4A, and you've knocked off two of those teams this year, and you went down the wire with the rest, and now you're going in the second round with the Ankenys and the Valley on Thursday.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, it's simple things. I mean, I could go on our mental errors or, like, random turnovers, or we had a couple of breakdowns defensively, but overall I thought it was solid. Cash kind of killed us, but, you know, we're not focused on him. We're focused on their three main scorers, so it's not surprising when a guy like that can – he's a great senior, holy cow, when a guy like that can carve you up. But, I mean, even just our spacing, you know, we get really aggressive, which is great downhill, but then we get away from our spacing, we're clogging up the lane, or – there's no one for anybody to kick it to in transition or off of a drive. So these are fixable things, but I just feel like we're always trying to fix one thing. So the thing about this group is we get Joe Broderick, who scored 2 points tonight, obviously disappointed, sell out, bang himself in the wall like a hockey player, save a ball, and we go on a 9-1 run because of it. I mean, that kind of stuff makes me think that this is a team that's going to do something extremely special. We just need to get over the hump for some of these other things.
Well, Ankeny got out to a 20-9 first quarter lead, and you battled back from that 11-point deficit to cut it to 5 at halftime by outscoring Ankeny 21-15 in the second quarter and outscoring them 11-8 in the third. And the momentum shifted. You also got the game tied before the Hawks outscored you in the fourth quarter 23-19. You were there, but then, like you said, there's just multiple things happen that don't go right, and empty possessions, fouls, and whatnot. But impressed with that second quarter bounce back.
For sure. I mean, we spend all the time trying to set up a great game plan for the first quarter, and I'm not sure we've been doing a great job of that. I feel like we've out-schemed ourselves the last three losses we've had, where we've kind of put ourselves in a bad spot. Maybe it was a press that we shouldn't have been in, or a defensive assignment we should have been in, shouldn't have been in. But we need to get out to better starts defensively for sure. And, you know, that was a slow start to the game. I think it was 4-2 forever, mm-hmm. But then they blow it up to 20-9. And, you know, I'll be kicking myself for a while on how we get to that point. You know, is it a personnel thing? Is it scheme thing? But it's definitely something we have to fix, because we continue to lose the first quarter and then end up losing by less points than we lost the first quarter.
Well, I thought your team battled back. I mean, and if you could figure out as a coach, you can figure out, you know, how to get kids to finish, you know, please share, because that's probably the hardest thing to really get high school kids to get them to finish. You start the second or the fourth quarter just down two. You have them right where you want them, and the things that worked for you so well to fight back, you talked about finishing at the rim that you didn't do against Johnston. Well, the kids were finishing at the rim through three quarters. It just seemed like during the fourth quarter, it just wasn't going for you or those guys at the rim, and I thought that was costly in that fourth quarter.
Yeah, for sure. A lot of missed layups. You know, and they made some big plays. That three by Johnson with Maddox with his hand in his face, I mean, there's nobody else in the league that can do that. I mean, you could say Winkle, but it's not like that. It's not as impressive as that. They also had a kick out that was really big. They got us scrambling and hit a three. We were just one step behind all night, and, you know, not being able to get to the free throw line as much. I mean, we were just pounding the paint, two hands on us, no call. You know, it kind of wears you down, but we need to be stronger. I mean, we spent – I would bet that teams don't lift as much as we do over a year. We got to be better around the rim, you know, whether we're fouled or not. I never call them in practice, so we got Jonathan with the pad beating them up every day. So just got to be better around the rim, and, I mean – The spacing's a problem, too. They're always bringing the second guy over, and we're not ready to kick it.
Visit with Justin Einerson, the Dowling boys basketball coach, following Ankeny's win tonight, 66-60 over the Maroons, as Dowling prepares for the final two games of the week, Thursday and Friday, at Valley and at Southeast Polk. These are both rematches. The downside is, Coach, you have practice tomorrow. I know it's a Wednesday, so the practice is limited, and the kids got to have their legs and ready to go for the final two games this week.
BJ knew what he was doing, setting this up on a Thursday, for sure. These Catholic kids got to leave early. I mean, we wouldn't go that hard anyway tomorrow. We need to get our legs under us. We need to get a ton of shots up, some finishing, and then work on our game plan. The nice part is we've already done the Valley game plan a couple of times because we didn't know what was going to happen.
Oh, that's right. Yep.
So at least it's not as big of a prep for us. But I tell you what, Friday will be a really big prep because we play a very different style against Southeast Polk. So that'll be interesting to see how our guys rebound back-to-back.
All right, Coach. We appreciate you taking time to visit with us. Safe travels home with the fog and whatever it is, ice, be careful with that. And we'll be on the road again Thursday night. We'll be with you. This time we'll put Mr. Cataldo next to the
scorer's
bench. We won't be on the baseline like we are here.
Oh, perfect.
We'll be on the scorer's bench at Valley's after they put us there. Of course, he's got the ends with
Rose. You just get warnings.
I didn't realize I was going to get mic'd up.
I mean, you got a warning tonight. I mean, if you're going to get it.
Oh, yeah. Well, he's given me plenty of texts in the past. So I think that I get a different logo on my chest, and all of a sudden they treat me with a little more respect.
Hey, he's been in the league 8 years, Jimmy. Yeah. He's
you got a different logo. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. They go after you.
Yeah. Well, it's got a cross on this one.
Exactly. So you got to be careful.
Buy some time. Coach Einerson, thanks, and we'll talk to you Thursday.
All right, thanks.
You bet. Justin Einerson, our guest here on the postgame show, following Ankeny's win, and it's a split here tonight. The Dowling girls a winner, and the Ankeny boys a winner. Jimmy, any final comments? Anything you want to?
Yeah, I mean, you can hear the frustration, in Coach Einerson's, voice and his tone, and it's just extremely tough when you're in many, many games and you just can't come away with victories. And, the teams, they're out there. They're trying their hardest, and they're battling with these guys. And just when you need shots the most, you seem not to get them. But then your opponents hit big shots, and he's right. I thought they did a fairly good job limiting Joensen until he hit that big three-pointer in the fourth quarter. And then the kickout to Rio Aguirre was a big shot. And those two three-pointers really – but to be really costly for the Maroons in the fourth quarter.
Well, they certainly did. Well, do you get clearance to get into the Valley Bill Cold Iron Fieldhouse on Thursday?
And then you turn around and play Valley, which they're getting to that point in their season where all their guys are healthy. And
yeah, they are getting healthy.
And they're just such a dangerous team to any team in the state.
Well, Valley was at Joensen tonight, so.
I think it was tied at halftime.
Okay, so you were looking ahead a little bit. So, well, good. Well, we'll be there Thursday night, courtside, and keep an eye on. Boy, sometimes those clipboards might get loose. You never know. You never know. But we'll be there. And Jimmy, thanks for being alongside here tonight. Of course, it was 1 week ago tonight that you had to be the Mr. Uber driver for me, and hopefully that's all worked out. And then Friday night, did you ever make it out to pick up your nephew? You had some issues?
No, my friends and my cousins, they took care of him. So
okay.
Yeah, everybody chips in, unlike, sometimes in your world. Hey, Mark, I need a ride. And then all of a sudden you have a doctor's appointment.
I don't remember that, but that's okay. Well, listen, we'll see you anyway Friday night. If you can get through Brad Rose and security at Valley, you can join us here on the boys contest.
Got
How's
it.
That? All right. Jimmy Cataldo, my broadcast partner here. And that'll wrap things up from the Ankeny Gym. Our thanks to, the guy back in the studio enduring all this. That's Brady Grimm. And we want to thank him, along with Alexia, who helped us out a little bit during the girls' game from Oot Feedem in Dowling. We appreciate her work. And our thanks to everybody here at Ankeny. Head girls basketball coach Nate Toby in his first year, along with Ankeny boys basketball coach Brant Carlson. We appreciate all their efforts. Athletic director Mike Baker, Tom Day, Lisa Maker, our thanks to the fine Ankeny staff here. And on the Dowling side, athletic director Tom Wilson, Colleen Webb, Jared Herring back at the Dowling athletic office, and of course everybody involved. We want to thank also our are underwriters and supporters of Iowa Catholic Radio. This is our 47th year of broadcasting Dowling Catholic Sports. And our thanks back at the studio to Matt Wilkham, Deacon Mark Campbell, and all the fine folks there. For my broadcast partner, Scott Babinet and Jimmy Cataldo, this is Mark Amadil. For our producer, Brady Grimm, final scores for the final time tonight in the girls' contest. It was third-ranked Dowling defeating 7th-ranked Ankeny, 56-27. And the boys' contest was 9th-ranked Ankeny defeating Dowling, 66-60. Our next broadcast will be this Thursday night. 6 o'clock will go on the air, Dowling at Valley from the Bill Coldiron Fieldhouse at Valley High School. Join Scott Babinet, Jimmy Cataldo, and me for the broadcast beginning Thursday night. For everybody involved, this is Mark Amadale saying goodnight and so long from the Ankeny Gym one final time. From all of us at Iowa Catholic Radio, have a safe and blessed faith-filled evening.
Coverage of Dowling Catholic Sports is underwritten by Ashworth Vision Clinic, Construction Professionals, Klein Electric, Blessman International, Fast Signs, the Catholic Tuition Organization, Skeffington's Formal Wear, and Bozen the Florist. Please support the businesses that underwrite Iowa Catholic Radio. The preceding has been a Dowling Catholic Sports presentation on Iowa Catholic Radio.